Stab, stab, stab.
Cool mask.
We don't have a mask. Or a knife.
We don't. But, ironically enough, I did just clock this. Eminem isn't this week. Totally didn't do that on purpose.
Oh, wow. That's probably why he released it this week.
Yeah, actually, it makes perfect sense. It's Friday the 13th, everybody. Or was Friday the... You know what? Why'd I break the illusion? It is Friday the 13th when we're recording this. And, sure. And we had a big week this week. We're excited to go through... We have an artist this week, which, if I'm being quite frankly honest, it trumps everything else.
Like, oh, yeah.
I'm excited for the very song clear. Still, but, like, I would... We're so excited for the Weeknd song. It's at the end of the video, but we're so excited. But we're not going to let that take away from the other artists.
Oh, wait, that's what you're excited for? I was excited for Doechii.
Well, that's the first song this week, so... You don't even gotta wait. You don't even gotta wait. We got Katy Perry, NMF.
Oh, it was Katy Perry.
Is this NMF 89 or 90?
89.
Oh. Wow, it's the last of the 80s. Great decade. Great little. Can we get a round of applause for just the 80s of NMF? What a great decade of, you know, what a great decade.
Really, as old as Nancy Pelosi.
What a great. If I'm being honest. Fighting an urge to say something. Why are if we're fighting the odd? I mean, the last what?
When you evolve Nancy Pelosi.
Stop making fun of me, okay? The last 20 NMFs have just been. We've been on a good run here, okay? We've had a lot of good NMFs in the past little while. I think we're doing good. We had a bit of a dull period somewhere in the middle of that, like early 70s and late 80s have been baller, kick ass though. Either way, I mean, we've made 89 of these. This is the 89th one we're doing.
Yeah.
Makes you want to go back to the September of 2022? Where we were talking about starting the channel and, like, the July and everything. Yeah. We're waiting for you to finish. Was it school? And we were like, oh, I can't wait to start the channel. And then look at us now. 2 years later from that point, making another shitty video for nobody. To give a shit about. We made it. This is what fame is like. All right, everybody. Katy Perry, I'm His, He's Mine, featuring Doechii. Let's get this bitch started. I'm not calling them bitches. I need to say that immediately. It's just I'm excited for the song. Sort of.
Katy Perry's first two songs were trash, so let's see how
they were not good. But luckily, we have an artist such as Doechii who's just inspirational. Doechii, yeah. He says totally non-sarcastically. I'm his queen, I'm his freak, I'm every woman he wants and needs. I'm his dream, I'm his drug, I'm every woman he wants, so what? I'm his boss, I'm that bitch, I'm every woman he knows exists. I'm his main, I'm his side, I'm every woman that's in his mind. So I have a question. Three questions and the most non... This is not a rude question, okay? I don't care what you do, okay? Why is Katy Perry never wearing clothes anymore? Is it just like the... Is that just that we're going back?
I don't know. She lost them somewhere.
Someone's got to help her find them.
Left them in a construction yard.
Yeah, well, someone has got to help her find them, okay? Because it's starting to seem... I'm not saying that... I don't mind she's wearing clothes. I know the hate comments are coming. Oh, look at these... Fucking, you'll never get a girlfriend. We've heard it, okay? You can't fucking, okay? We actually have heard that one. We actually heard it, like, multiple times, funny enough. But no, we've also heard from a million Taylor Swift fans that there's a girl out for us and we're nice young men, so fuck you. And but what I'm saying is, like, why?
Taylor Swift over Katy Perry.
Yeah, every day. And that's where we, and by the way, and that's where we
and, get, and,
that's
and the world seems to agree, so,
in every metric ever, but.
For every, like, two or three people still defending Katy Perry, there's, like, 100 Taylor Swift fans ready to kill you. So...
Yeah. Good luck. Good luck. This is
good
how...
Good luck. We're on side with them.
Yeah, this is how... I imagine this is how everyone who tried to fight the fucking Mongolian Empire felt. Or the Roman Empire. They were saying, well, we're fucked. So we just gotta accept defeat. someone needs help to find them. Because it's starting to seem like she's... Might be... selling sex instead of music, but I could be wrong. You know, who am I, right? Just a man who's apparently a misogynist.
Yeah, well, it's because the music got shit.
Yeah, it really... It could be a double whammy, but instead it's just disappointing. Okay, God. Jesus Christ. Relax.
She's 40.
This is a wild thought. You know how hard it is to look... God, you know how hard it is to look up this much? They're changing the camera so much. I'm doing my best to be respectful, young man. And then you gotta hear from people, just fucking stop commenting already and look! Look at her! It's like, I don't wanna, I just wanna see her as a person and not an object! And they're like, no. Good. Okay. Had a bit of a technical issue, but it's fine. What do we got? We'll give this another 40 seconds just to, I don't know, just see if maybe anything interesting happens. Dylan, did you just say something? Fuck. Hold on. God. Hold on. There's no audio coming from you. Okay, so hold on. I can fix this. Okay, so basically, yeah. I'm gonna have to ramble on about the same thing I've already talked about just to kind of while I'm fixing this. But no, yeah. Like I said, it literally has nothing to do with the fact that I'm like trying to control women or anything. It's just, can you say something, Dylan?
Hola.
Okay, I fixed it. Yeah, but it has nothing to do with controlling women as much as it has to do with like. As much as it has to do with, like, trying to make myself better and actually view people the right way. And the same thing with Dylan here. So it's like, just, it should just remain in marriage. And it should not be fucking, you know. Dylan, say something. You can't hear me, can you? Okay, all right, hold on. All right, we're back after issue. We are back. I don't know exactly where we were because it played for a second.
We were at the part where her ass Katie was wearing nothing. Yeah, like, okay. I don't know. That's the whole video.
Okay, well, yeah, so, great. This should be good. It's a cool car. I like that. I like the chrome. Imagine how dirty it gets, though. You know how hard it would be to, like, keep that car clean? Who's driving? You deserve every ounce of that. All right, we've heard enough. I think we're good.
Yeah, like keep going? So the song, it's the worst of the three singles.
I think worst is an understatement. It's pretty bad. I do like that there's a naked man, too. You know, that kind of evens out, you know? You know?
Yes, because we've got to make sure that the gay men are also horny.
Got to sell. Yeah. Holy shit! Right,
yeah, that was, like, so holy fucking
holy shit,
atrocious.
Dylan, you made a mistake.
What?
Look at the bottom of the blue.
Yep.
Dylan's favorite song ever. Sorry. Anyway, go back. No, I yeah, no, terrible. If it was a different me at a different time, I would watch it, but let's just leave it at not for the music.
It sounds like Katy Perry is gonna actually contend Camila for worst album of the year. Which is interesting.
Pretty bad. Oh, okay, so it just gets worse. Okay, well.
Okay.
Dylan, yeah, okay, cool. Well, we'll move on. The next is FKA Twigs. I don't know how to pronounce that, but Dylan, I've never heard FKA Twigs. I think you listened to an FKA Twigs album, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, I have
Which
no idea.
Pretty good, so.
I have no idea what I'm getting myself into, even remotely. I know nothing about them. I don't know if it's a dude, a girl. I know nothing. At all. So, band
it's
person.
A girl, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, you're pretty sure. You better say that shit very clearly. Let's go. Is this who's? Well, that's why you gotta be. That's why you gotta say pretty sure. Just in case. Okay. Oh.
Did you see the new comments?
I haven't. Were they on
Creepspace? Oh, she's British.
It reminds me of, weirdly enough, it seems like almost Doja Cat. I'm getting, like, the Doja Cat, visually, they look similar. Am I wrong?
Yeah, she's just got more hair.
Yeah. Which is right by her. It's a good idea. Teams on chat. She's got the Halsey cut, and the new, the rock song she just did. The music video. Not the arithmetics looking one, but this.
That's why I'm standing here physically right now.
Sorry for talking to the video, guys.
Hello, Kronkorb, Twig speaking.
Twig. So her name's Twig. Okay, cool. It would be a little bit weird to go by FKA, right? Like, it's kind of some gang shit, though. You feel like you answer a call, you're like, "What's up? It's FKA." Like that's a Logan Paul vlog right there. That's 2018.
I mean, FKA typically means formerly known as.
Oh, so she. Oh, I didn't even know that. I'm challenged. So wait. So you're not. So you were formerly known as Twigs. Now you're just Twig. Got you. I'm caught up. All caught up on the lore.
Whoa.
Damn. I feel like my life is about to change forever. Either that or I'm going to be...
Pause.
I mean, I paused it at 50. What are you doing? Taking notes? It's like Simon Cowell. You look like Simon Cowell on AGT. Someone messaged you? Well, they can fucking wait. Is your attention not... I'm sorry. Are the people watching this video not important enough to you? Distract yourself, why don't you?
Okay.
Fucking asshole.
Let's go. Continue.
Fuck, drink his coffee like this. Let's go. Let's go, Twig. This is a neat dance right here. Tell you what. It makes me... I don't...
We're gonna get some Ray stuff, yeah.
I mean, I don't know. It's just dance. I mean, dance is cool. Well, it was until that. I don't know if it's, like, cool anymore or if, like, Satan's about to come out. That was cool. That's some hella upper body strength right there. Shout out. I can't do that. I'd tear my hamstring, bro. Fuck that. Fuck that. Well, that was an electrifying time. Now we gotta pause it again for copyright, guys. That was electrifying, life-changing. We're making our way through it. It's kind of cool so far. I'm kind of having some trouble keeping up, but... Probably because I talked over the beginning, but... Oh, what the... Okay, we're not what wearing clothes now. All right, yep. Okay. Katy Perry's back.
So when's the song gonna start?
It's starting now. Doja Cat. Yeah, I see. I gotta pause it. Oh, why? There's more naked men than I thought I'd see today. This is the second half-naked man we've seen. In just the last 5 minutes. NMF has taken... I was just talking about how good NMF is, but I feel like it's taken a real fall. It's just turned into glorified gay porn at this point.
We hope you're entertained, people.
We hope you're entertained. That's a man and is quite possibly a penis under there. Who knows? at this point. Anyway, we continue.
Quite possibly.
My favorite skill that I've had to... What letter is that? Q W E. Shorty's a huge fan of the letter E. Is there a reason? Maybe she's stuck in the middle of writing. Someone's pissing on the floor, I think. I don't know what's happening. I guess this is like a symbolism of life. So you got boss yelling at you, and you kind of you get a call from. I didn't hear what the call was. Do you remember what the call was? Or did they say it? Or was it just kind of you couldn't tell? I don't think you could tell. And then you have like everything kind of. I guess it's stuff. It's like living in life. You have all the shit freaking out, flipping upside down, and falling apart. So we'll see what's happening now, maybe, and start trying to break into it, and figure out what's happening. All right. Well, my guess was right. I said there's a high possibility Satan fucking comes out soon, and I was right. I fucking called it, bro. You know, there's only two things worse you can get than ritualistic dancing. It goes fucking Satan, and if it really goes bad, Meghan Trainor will come out. Dylan, you did this to me. You did this to us. This is too much for me.
What the fuck?
God.
Don't pause. I think we're...
No, we're not. We're good. We were good. But I will say, this is the... I have we had enough? Or are we in it for the long haul at this point?
Do we have to see
this one through? I'll leave it up to you.
I mean, I guess we'll see it through. We're here already.
Fuck it, we've gotten this far into hell. Might as well just go ahead and walk through it. See what they got going on down here. Jesus. I know this is like super artistic, and I'm sure to a lot of people this is really cool. It's a little much. For me.
Doja Cat's sitting on the side clapping.
This is still cooler than what Doja Cat's got going on.
True.
She hasn't said, hey, we love Satan, I'm doing everything for Satan yet, so that's a big step. Next line. That was close. Say, it was close. Eusexua, you're right. That sounds like Biba Doobie in the right ear. The Biba Doobie starts doing this shit, I'm out. The music's great, but no. It is cool, though. A lot of energy being put into it. That man is so... That is the most obvious ball cap I've seen on that Asian fellow to the right. Is it a ball cap? What am I looking at? What's happening? What are they wearing? I just clocked that. Knee pads? Bald cap, some of them.
What the hell?
Alright. What the fuck is happening? I know there's somebody like, guys, you guys piss me off. You're missing the point. What point? I'm watching a woman and I'm watching Doja Cat and a bunch of naked men crawl on the ground. Well, that Asian fellow wears a bald cap and some fucking arm braces. I don't know what's happening. This is very fucking confusing. Alright, this is confusing. I don't know what's happening. This is more confusing than the first... There's nowhere I can go without ass peeing in my face! God! The confusing... This is more confused than the... This is leaving me more confused than the first person we saw in this video. Look, ass. Just get it away. Look.
It's an ass copter.
I have some. For someone, we're not just being a dick to her, by the way. Before this, we had fucking Doechii and Katy Perry just fucking doing splits on cars and skydiving butt ass naked. And, like, it's just. I'm so tired of it, bro. I'm just tired of seeing naked people. I mean, fuck. Ugh. I'm tired. I'm tired, Grandpa.
Come on. Get back up, kitty cat.
Okay, now we're... Is there actually some symbols in the video, do you think? Or is it like, let's just do some right crazy shit? I think that I think there's
probably
some,
there is of some sort.
I can't. We're gonna have to Google after this video. Bart was pissing me off because he keeps like I'm laying him on my my like lap, but he doesn't like how it is. So he gets down and then proceeds to claw my fucking arm so he can get back up. And then I get him back up and he doesn't like it, so he gets down and then he claws. He's done it 5 times already. He did it again. He just fucking smacked my hand. Quit fucking with me, you ass. Fine, I'm holding you, motherfucker, and you're gonna like it. You're gonna just sit up here, and I don't care if it's uncomfortable. You're around. You're watching this shit now too, Bart. Welcome to hell. Hell yeah, I do that shit all the time. It's a donkey kick. It's great for the glutes.
Oh, let me do a donkey kick.
It's great for the glutes. Bart, you're choking yourself. Relax.
Yeah.
Damn, the gyat is just out of frame. They can't see it. You're kind of blocking them.
Donkey kick.
It just lagged so bad. You're not supposed to touch your... You keep your back straight, and you kick out your legs, and your knees can't go above where your waist is. That's what a donkey kick is. But you're not supposed to touch your feet. I just, like... It's the closest thing I could think of. Bart, if you call me again, I'm gonna send you to wherever the fuck they are. You don't want to go there. You gotta start learning interpretive dance. That's gotta be. It's cool when they do it, right? I have time to run it for 5 more. Okay, I'm gonna pause it again anyway, so fuck it. This is probably about... I feel like this is what indoctrination felt like feels like. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like in, like, every, like, major, like, city, you know what I mean? Like, you have to watch a video like this, and you come out of it, and you're like, I'm gonna try drugs, you know? Like, this video, let's... I'm gonna try drugs and get someone pregnant or get pregnant. This is what they watch in, like, big city high schools, and they come out of it like that, you know? This is what... I think Kim Jong-un shows the North Koreans.
No. He doesn't show them that. He shows them the last song.
No, they don't see that. That's illegal. Yeah, you can't do that in North Korea. You get killed for that in North Korea. Yeah, you can't do that. If you show that in North Korea, man, I think it would probably... You show that to a man in North Korea, I don't know what's going
to happen. They'd probably just play the audio of Camila's album. That's probably what Kim uses.
No, they probably played KSI's music.
No. I'd much rather hear Holiday than I love it.
No, dude, I love you didn't get it. I love KSI's music. It was a reference to Quideca. But they torture people with the music out in North Korea. He's not British. I don't know why I did an accent, but it just sounded like an accent when he did it. Everyone can have their own Quideca, okay? I envision Quideca with an accent. It's like, what is Quideca? Like Jesus and Talladega Nights? It's a cool nose ring. Too far, then refuse to help me. I was on the edge of something greater than before, but nobody told me. Great, now they're with us. Now these motherfuckers are going to be in our lives. This reminds me of the zombies from I Am Legend is what it reminds me of. Reminds me of the zombies from I Am Legend. Those fuckers are... They get burnt when they go into sunlight. It's such a good fucking... If anyone here has ever... Oh, that's our ending? Really? They're now with us? That's fucking terrifying. It's like we just watch Satan get fucking... summoned from the Satan, and they're like, we're here. And it's like, what? You just left me on that? You just told me we're basically fucked and walked away? Alright, anyway. What do we think? God, get it away. This is a terrible start, isn't it?
Okay, the song, I actually didn't mind it.
I did, I don't like it. But that's like, just me. It's done. It's cool.
I wasn't a fan of the first part, but I actually liked the second part.
I was too distracted, if I'm being honest.
It was just the first part I didn't really like. But overall, I mean, it's fine. It's certainly better than the first song we had, so.
I'm gonna say no. I don't like the video. I don't like the song. Nothing to say. A lot of effort, though, which is nice. They put effort into it, which is the important part. If someone could explain it to us in the comments, I might change my opinion on it. Anyway, we got Fat Joe, Anita, and DJ Khaled, Paradise.
Might be good to know Anita's also here selling sexual stuff.
Well, we knew that.
Here it is.
It's gonna happen! Yes! We gotta go back. Not too far back. I don't want to... Okay. Hold on, I gotta go back enough, I swear to... Okay, good, perfect timing.
Oh,
alright, let's go, let's shut the fuck up. He's talking. We the best music. If it was up to them, they would want us in a dinghy with holes in it, so we can't get to the yacht. Another one. If it was up to them. What the fuck did he just say? It's up to them, they would want us in a dinghy with holes in it, so we can't get to the yacht. What? Does anyone know what the fuck he just said? Who let him in the studio? I'm just kidding. That's the most poetic shit I ever heard in my life. And actually, DJ Khaled could get me to run through a wall. Let me get a DJ Khaled tattoo. I can't pull up a page. Genius doesn't even know. Look, they've accepted defeat. I Googled it. I said, what is Genius? What did they say? And Genius said no. I can find any Young Thug and Gunna lyric, but that's where they drew the line. If it was up to them, they would want us in a dinghy with holes in it, so we can't get to the yacht. What the fuck is a dinghy? I thought he said a thingy. I thought he just didn't know the name for it. A dinghy... A what? So what I'm saying is he really did say thingy. Oh, it is? Oh, so he's sinking in a... I thought he said they want us in a thingy with holes in it, so we can't. I thought he just said thingy. I was like, this motherfucker just said thingy is the intro to a song, and he couldn't figure out what he was talking about, and he just left that in the song. You're like, what's that thingy? The thingy with holes in it. He just. fuck it. Sure, they'll figure it out.
Oh my god. If it was up to them. Crack.
Oh, now. Big Joe now. Yeah, we're good now. That's all we need to hear. Do you want to hear a second of Big Joe? Just a second. We'll see. Fat Joe. So Fat Joe, biggest.
No,
Joe
I actually want to hear the song.
I do too. I wonder why you want to see the video, Dylan. Gotta be ashamed of yourself.
I want to see Fat Joe.
I can't, I tell you what, somebody's got this shit out to me. These pauses are not intentional. Somebody's got shit out for me, I swear. Every time I pause it, it's just ass. The past three songs. is this just this week, right? Has this been every week? I mean, damn, bro. You think I was in a fucking
ass?
Back and forth, she just rocking her hips. Hey, might have to leave the spot up with this. Stars in the roof, she see rocks on my wrist. She wanna make TikToks in the whip. Crack. Feels like paradise. Ocean water coming down your thighs. Can you feel me? Feels like paradise. No, no, no. Feels like paradise. Every day. Yeah, we're good. Fat, can I say something? I'm going to say something out of pocket. Fat Joe's a terrible rapper. All right, I said it. I've been meaning to say it for a long time.
I know. It's just kind of... It's not good. I mean, it's not like outright terrible, but it's like...
No, it's
know,
not terrible. It's not
it's,
terrible.
It's there.
Yeah.
I think
right.
DJ Khaled saved it.
Yeah, DJ Khaled did the best part, and the beat was pretty solid. Everything else was ass. Literally, it's like, literally, the video was just ass. Every time, the whole time, I was like, Fat, move to the side.
Funny, like, I like how DJ Khaled, though, now, rather than just saying another one DJ Khaled, is actually, like, giving us little speeches and quotes.
Yeah. Like he's like, here's my impression. He's like, DJ
Khaled. A dinghy with holes in it.
DJ Khaled. They need to make the Pringles cans bigger. I can't fit my hand in. I have to turn it upside down. Another one. Like, it's just like little speeches. DJ Khaled. Oh, my God. DJ Khaled. Anybody else get hungry at night? just keeps the songs about fucking doing drugs. Anybody else not pay their taxes? No, just me. Another one. Oh fuck, Shawn Mendes. Nobody knows. Let's just jump. Oh, I didn't turn the fucking.
His last couple were bangers.
Banger is an understatement. I've been practicing YMY on guitar and singing it every day. It's my practice song. That and Stick Season right now. When your touch walks me home. When you taste this good. When the glitters is gone. Cool ass video already. I have to pause it. This is very different, but I like it. It sounds like Zach Bryan. Different, though. It doesn't sound exactly like Zach Bryan. The instrumental sounds like a Zach Bryan instrumental. The vocals don't.
Mm. Yeah.
Zach Bryan didn't invent this sound. I know, everybody. Don't worry. I'm just saying what it's all I know. This feels bluesy, too. Yeah, this is bluesy. Alright, really cool. Sound of it's really cool.
Really nice.
Yeah, I really like it a lot. The writing's neat, too. I didn't hear a lot of the first, so I couldn't really understand it too much, so I'm not fully keeping up, so I can't judge the writing yet, but after the second verse, I'll be able to judge it a little bit better. You're an amateur drunk and everyone knows it. I'm gonna pause it because then we can just run it out. Really cool so far. I like it a lot, actually. I'm loving this new Shawn Mendes right now. It's really nice. Really nice. Folk and country is really the new way. And I've yet to see somebody like fully kind of put blues into that. So this is actually really neat. It's like, unique too.
And kind of crazy that Camila is having the polar opposite of a year.
Yeah, he definitely won the breakup.
Yeah.
You know what? Lost the breakup. Whose song is that? Is Maisie Peters had a song called Lost the Breakup?
Yeah.
Well, we know who lost the breakup. Never heard the song. I have heard the song. I just don't know if that's what it was about. Look at Sean being goofy. It's a little too close to those dudes, though. He's not beating the rumors. He's not beating the allegations with that. Three shirtless men cuddling in a bar. It's normal. I really like all the backing throughout this thing, too, and, like, the... Ooh, that was cool. I liked that a lot. It's kind of quick, though, but that's fine.
You give your little thoughts? I've got to go.
Play why. Okay, hold on. Let's see if I can remember. Hold up. Bart's in my lap. I don't want to, like, neglect my kitty cat. Relax, buddy. You're going to have to help me hold my guitar without killing you. Hold on. Well, how do you play this song? Wait. Oh, fuck me. You know what? This is what I get. I learned Stick Season without, like, I learned a bunch of other songs. The one song the song I'm learning next, like, to fully remember is Why. So I pissed myself off now. Because this was my moment, and I fucked it up. Excuse my language, everybody. If anyone's mother is watching. Oh, yeah, here we go. Playing guitar. Just vibe out for a minute. I can't sing right now. My voice is not ready.
I don't know. When I start to get real sick of all the people being dicks, I have to go out and commit crimes.
I gotta finish the chorus. It's just one more chord. Oh, fuck. I fucked up. Alright, that was our little, moment. That was
That's a contender for my favorite single. Like, Why was terrific, but...
I still like Why more, but that was really good.
That one was... That one's kind of contending for... I honestly... And the other one wasn't far off Why in the other video, so they're all pretty similar.
I think the only thing they might struggle
with is consistent run.
I'm definitely checking out the album. But I really like... I really like it's very unique thing that happens on it catches me off guard because when practicing and I forget about it, but like on that third verse where like he's in the middle of the end of the chorus, right? But it's such an abrupt change to I thought I was about to be a father. It's a really cool way they did that in the song. But we'll move on. Love that. You didn't say your thoughts. Oh yeah, you kind of did.
Anyway, wasting
you. I did.
Yeah, you did. Well, you really just said you liked it and that it was a contender for the other ones. That's all you
said. I mean, it's a 2.5 minute song. There's not too much to say about it.
Well, he gets on me when I don't say
anything.
There
were nice little things going on in the background there.
Good. That's all you need to say.
Much to say. Yeah.
Yeah, you didn't have to say more. I was just making a point because you always get on my ass. Teddy Swims, Bad Dreams.
Whoa.
My bad. I mistyped. He always gets in my ass. Let's go, Teddy. My big old teddy bear. I just want to give a big old hug. A little kiss on the forehead. Tell us. Oh, fuck
me. We should just call this New Music Friday edition us.
We already have an idea. It's Friday the 13th, baby.
Screw that. It's us now.
I don't think we can do that. That could get the video. I could get the video. That might not work. I thought we found out the cuss words were bad. Cool video. All white suits are cold. I would never invest in an all white suit, though, because my fat ass would totally get sauces and condiments of all sorts on it.
Get seasonings and condiments and crumbs of all sorts, bro.
It would take 35 seconds. My fat ass be in the corner with a burger. Fucking. God. He got ketchup on his bitch already. Oh, shit. If I ever get rich, I'm just gonna, like. I don't know. I'm gonna buy an all white suit.
If I get rich, I'm gonna buy a bus.
I'm so happy. So happy that I clocked we were in a Streamlabs because I had a terrific response in a Streamlabs in a video because I was about to say some shit. Fuck it.
Yeah,
This one does feel different than the other ones, though, to a certain degree. This is the most different sounding one I've heard him do. It's still a similar sound, but it is the most different. It's more up-tempo than usual.
Here's a good question. Does Teddy swim?
That's actually a good question. I don't know, but those glasses should not work so well with that outfit, what they do. You know? Those glasses look like he got them in a Happy Meal. Or like he won them in a claw machine.
Also, are we stepping into a new era? Because he had like an orange theme going for everything, and now he's got white and red. So
yeah, we are. This is the period and tampon combo era. It's just all a big Tampax commercial.
Damn.
Just a brand deal. Mountains and the sun rising is a cool shot. Where do they film this, or is it all like fake?
It looks like a subway station.
Yeah, but it does not look real, though, in a lot of areas. A lot of it's not real, obviously, it's not. But, like, I think it might be somewhat real, somewhat not. It could be a subway station. This is it. Yeah, this is fake. Yeah, it's fake. Okay. It's fake, too. See the really big room, or he's small. It actually reminds me of... What did that remind you of? Yeah or nay? What'd you think of? It immediately reminded me of Bo Burnham. Because it cuts to the shot of him sitting in the chair in the room. And immediately the first thought you have is, damn, he's big. And then he goes, I know what you're thinking. He looks right at the camera and goes, is this a really small... I mean, is that a really big man or a really small room? And he says, it's a small room. I mean, he said both. I think it was both. I don't remember. I need to rewatch Inside. That's so good. Sorry.
Because he's like 6'5 or some shit.
6'7, I think. He's big. Damn. He's tall. Tall. He's a tall dude. That's why he's so good at piano. Long ass fingers. I know what else he's good at. Reaching shit. I actually like the song. It's a really nice rhythm to it. Gave me flashbacks of the rug cleaning channels. It's always an unnecessary amount of effort. That is actually, I really like that instrumental though. You hear that shit? That's so well done all the way around. Good, great instrumentation. Oh, now he's really where he was. Okay. Well, you got out of this fucking possibly CGI subway. It's a good job. Is this the lore where Teddy Swims is actually the guy in Subway Surfers? It's just Teddy Swims running from the police. Hear me out. You get it. Hear me out. Hear me out. Hold on. Hear me out. You get a date with Sydney Sweeney, but in 6 months, yes. you have to reach the highest score ever in Subway Surfers, and you have 6 months to do it. Fuck that. You have 2 weeks to do it. 3 weeks. I'll give you a month. How much of your time are you going to spend?
Yep.
For just the possibility of dating her, maybe, if she likes you? Wow, man. Scary part is
I guess I got a lot of sick days at work. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know what to tell you.
Scary thing is I'd do it too. Wow, what a terrible generation. Anyway,
if you guys see a massive gap with no videos for like a month, then you know what happened.
Just know it's time to get subwaying and surfing. Maybe them subways are gonna get surfed. All right. Tell you what, yeah, riding on that surfboard, grinding on that wood, grinding.
Oh yeah, no, song was really good.
You know who that is?
No.
It's Beyonce. I only know that from New Girl. the show because Nick's singing it. He's like, who's that? It's Beyonce. And she takes the headphones off and gets pissed off at him. The only reason I know that song. All right, what'd you think about the song?
No, it was really good.
Really good. I thought it was the most unique one so far, too, in this little run. It did it very different. The instrumentation was great. Anyway, we can go and jump, though. Pale Waves, I'm sorry, Cranberries, Thinking About You, they're back. They're back. Let's just say whatever ritual fucking FKA Twigs did earlier.
As Zach said, it's his favorite Scottish lesbian Cranberries cover band.
I said that in the confidence of privacy of my own home, you fucking bitch. And two, okay, yes, fine, well, I own up to it. I said what I said.
I said what I said. I've offended them because I've said exactly what they are. I didn't say Scottish.
I did not know that. I didn't assume where they were. I just said.
They are. Glasgow, the Scottish flag was in the last video. I think they're British. Scottish. I think we looked them up, didn't we?
They're British. I think they were British. I'm 90% sure they were British. But either way, this is relevant to the point, okay? I said that they were a lesbian Cranberries cover band. It was a joke, okay? Somewhat. They sound a lot like the Cranberries.
Whoops, they were formed in Manchester. Well,
they sound like the Cranberries, but they do have songs that I actually like as much as I like songs from the Cranberries. So I can't really just say they're a cover band because they've like made songs I like more, so I don't know. But Pale Waves, Thinking About You. I tell you what Dylan's thinking about. He's still thinking about Sydney. But like I said, Cranberries, they're back. Whatever ritual FKA Twigs did earlier brought her back. They're back. So they're kicking. They're back, everybody. The Cranberries. Sounds beautiful as always.
Get off her deck.
I can't. It's too big. I'm already. It's. I can't get off. It's stuck. I'm just happy we might actually have a music video without fucking overly sexualized. What? I just totally ignored Teddy. I'm sorry. I already have to pause it, I think. I wouldn't keep it up, but I don't want to get copyrighted. We have to pause it roughly every 50 seconds so we don't get copyrighted. So far, it sounds like similar to the other ones. Same, like, tone I like of the instrumentation. It sounds really, like, nice. I like it. You can't do that. You can't. Fuck! Every ounce of no, you didn't hear it. She used the fucking. She did the worst lyrical rhyme ever. And I think she did that in another song too. Am I tripping? I'm like 30% sure it's the second time she's done it. Girl and whirl are not allowed to be rhymed. You know better. You out of all people should know this, whatever your name is. You should know this.
It is not the worst lyrical thing you can do.
Hold on. Girl and World is like the most like. It is the, if you ask anybody ever, I've done my research. Okay, it's not just me. It is literally listed everywhere as the worst possible. That when and it's different. Rap has its own that's as bad. Lyrical Miracle, okay. Rap has its own.
Lyrical Miracle is so much worse than
it
Girl
is.
World.
It is. It is. But it's also rap is also like a. It's weird because rap is also like more. Overly used than so it's like I don't know it's Girl and World is okay I'm okay with it but we can't say you gave a girl the world or the girl was your world you can't say those two things.
There's a sheep in the background.
Were they at New Zealand? No, not New Zealand because Dylan's not.
Do the feelings linger?
You can't. Come on. Do the feelings linger? Are we fucking serious right now? Pale Waves, I love you, but we can't. You can't say linger. You're not allowed. You're banned.
Next verse is going to be like, I see you in my dreams.
I call your sister from town. I assume this is an album rollout, by the way.
Oh, it is, yeah.
That shit used to, the first time I heard this band, that like was weird to me, but now I've like just grown used to it. I kind of like it. I like their sound. I don't think it's a good song again. It's the writing is nothing special, but it sounds all right. Like, it's nothing crazy. It's very similar to the last two, but I do like it. I like the sound. Like, that's what I was trying to tell you. There's something sonically about the tone of the guitars and everything and her voice in production that it's like they probably really could just make anything and I would listen. Because it's just something about that sound that they use actually just gives me peace. So I felt like if I went into the Cranberries, I might be a big fan of them. The only issue I did find is, like Linger kind of does it too. But, like, the problem being is with the other ones is, like, some of the things I actually do like about Pale Waves is the modern sound, which Cranberries didn't do because they didn't have the technology for it. But I want to go into more Cranberries and see if I can find more songs because I might end up being a huge Cranberries fan. And, like I said, a huge Pale Waves fan once I go more into them too. I think I found my sound. You can't do that in the chorus. They fought every urge not to call this fucking song Linger. They're like, but Linger make that, we gotta do Linger. And they're like, we can't. I wonder if it was intentional. I don't know if I paused it in between. I really don't. Bro, what are you doing? Why are you? You look like you're fucking. Relax. You need to lower your motherfucking tone, buddy. All right, I need to. Me and Bart are about to tussle. You fat bastard! Lay off the cat. Actually, my sister's an ass. She walked in here, looked at him yesterday, and went
ass.
She walked in and said, "Bart, you can't say ass when I just said my sister like that." Anyway, she came in here and she looked at Bart, looked at him walking by and said, "Wow, Bart, you're getting fat." He is. He's fucking fat. Look at him. Hold on. I want to hold you the right way. I don't want you to get, look at his. Look at him. Look at belly, bro. It's fat bastard. But that's good. You're getting fat means you're eating good. That means we're doing good. It means you're fed. Okay, we have got...
The album is called Smitten and comes out on September 27th.
Well, neat. We have... I don't know what this is. I don't know if it's... It says, Demi Lovato, You'll Be Okay, Kid, from the original documentary, Child Star. So I guess they're making a documentary about it. Is it her documentary or is it someone else's documentary? It seems to be two people here.
It'll probably be something to do with her... Or maybe just something in general, because she was a child star.
Yeah, no, so I know. She's on Barney and a bunch of different... I know. But I'm curious, like, if this is, like, what happened? Is it, like, maybe, like, a follow-up for, like, the stuff that was... Maybe it's, like, in follow-up to the succession of... I don't know what it was called, but the Nickelodeon stuff that got happened. It's also on Hulu, so probably. Because Hulu did that one, and then they're probably doing this one as well. Which, fair do, it probably all does need to be covered. People need to realize what was going on. So, we'll listen to it. I used to love Demi Lovato back in the day. I can't say it's gone.
And then she shaved her head and fucked a ghost.
Which is, considering what could have happened, I'm going to let it slide. Although it is funny. Okay, it's not the shaving head and the bitch of breakdown's not funny. The fucking a ghost thing's funny. The rest isn't funny. But the, I think the last song I remember liking. I love Skyscraper, Heart Attack. There's some bangers back in the day. I even like Sorry Not Sorry, even though Dylan probably hates that song. There's some songs I did like. I haven't liked one in a while. So I'm looking forward to this. Maybe this will be a good little turn. But either way, I'm more so interested in what's going to be talked about more than the actual song. Camp Rock. Have you seen Camp Rock? Dylan, have you seen Camp Rock? Sorry, you're supposed to answer.
Probably.
Camp Rock.
I didn't watch much Disney Channel. I was more Nickelodeon person.
I'm surprised I don't get called, like, the reason, like, I'm surprised I don't get called gay more, because I can recite the entirety of, like, the Introducing Me song by Nick Jonas in that movie. I'm not going to do it.
Probably don't get called gay because it's probably a no-brainer. They probably just expect everyone to know. Nobody thinks about you and goes, oh, that guy who likes Camp Rock, definitely straight. He likes women.
Yeah, I'm saying, like, but, like, one of them are like, when I'm like, oh, yeah, I know Camp Rock, and I can't recite everything the girl said, but I can tell you what my man Nick Jonas said. I remember that now. Like, and then it's like, that's like a rough thing to get by, right? That's a rough thing to promote, you know? I just have a lot of sisters. This is a great movie. Nick Jonas is a handsome man. I'm straight. I like women, but we're all thinking. Heart, blowing out candles, wishing on stars. One day you'll blink. It's all gonna happen, but not how you think. Can't stop, you don't want to. Here's what I wish I knew. The sharks in the water will teach you to swim. The thorns on the roses will thicken your skin. Okay, bars, by the way. The writing's really good so far, actually. We get the sharks in the water teach you to swim. It's a bar. That's a bar. That's a bar. Also needed to pause it, so I just did what I did. I did what I had to. People might hurt you
and break promises, but darling, what song does this sound like from her? I know.
Reminds me of You're On Your Own, Kid, from Midnights.
No, it's but I mean, the song doesn't sound the same. The
title wise,
The title, well, yeah, you know. Happier reminds me of Happier, which reminds me of Happier. sorry, it's just right there. Three amazing songs called Happier, by the way. This reminds me of another. Oh, Stone Cold, fucking. Banger, incredible vocal performance. It's her song. It's called Stone Cold. This reminds me of Stone Cold. Slow down, deep breath. Don't let the monsters scare you to death. They'll try. She looks like Selena Gomez in that picture, weirdly enough. When did I play it? It was like right here, right? It wasn't long ago at all, was it?
Turns out they're twin sisters.
They were. I think they were on Barney together. And they had two movies together, I think.
Why am I so tired?
I'm telling you, I'm about to be really tired in a minute, because I've drinking two cups of coffee, and at some point they're going to go away, and when they do, I might just fall asleep mid-video.
Damn.
That would be unfortunate. That'd be the greatest clip on our channel ever, though. Me falling asleep and you, wake the fuck up! He's just trying to wake me up. That'd be the greatest clip ever. Well, unless I just don't wake up. Just for eight hours. 8 hours of footage of me sleeping and you just yelling at me.
No, and then I just start doing other shit. I just start like playing games. Then I go out to the club, come back, and then I'm like, you're still here.
Oh my god. Sorry, I got distracted, guys. I'll be okay, kid. You'll be okay, kid. You'll make it like I did. Well,
so, okay, no, I can't make that joke.
No, that's a good idea. So wait, so is there?
I'll tell you the joke after.
That's probably a good idea. But
I assume she's singing to the other kids.
Yeah, either that or she's singing to herself. I think she's singing to herself. Maybe it could be both.
I get it now. She's singing to a ghost.
Shut the fuck up. All right, we're done.
What? And what? That's out of her. She did it before.
Stop. This was actually a good
song.
Have
you not seen the time?
No,
that
I'm done. I'm
and
done.
She sung to
stop.
The ghost. I can hear the ghost. I'm gonna sing for him. He wants me to sing for him.
Okay, look. This is a good song with a good meaning, and a good little lyric video. This is just, let's just say, you did a great job. I liked it. The vocal performance is good. The songwriting
is
cool.
No, it's great.
It's a great message. Hopefully this
reminds us that even if she has gone crazy, she is still very talented.
Yeah, of course. I don't know if she's crazy. Hopefully she's doing good. I mean, I want everybody to do it.
She's definitely crazy.
At one point, she was crazy. I mean, you got to think about it. It's like, okay, Roger Waters was crazy, but look what he came out with, right? And you don't talk about how crazy, fucking batshit crazy he was, do you? No, you just listen to the albums. So it's like...
Yeah. But I mean, But that's the thing, though.
We've got good songs.
He was crazy. We got good songs from it. Demi Lovato, crazy. We're getting good songs from it.
So, you know, it's crazy because anyway. All right. We got Fuji. Fuji.
Fuji.
Fouché.
Fushi, which rhymes with booty, which rhymes with ass.
Let's go. It's because the theme of the video is ass, because all of his songs are ass. This one didn't sound ass when we heard it. The snippet of it. We haven't heard the song. I need to specify that. Heard the snippet. What is this? A fucking Shawn Mendes video part two? Is Zayn going to be here? How romantic. That's a nice ass motorcycle. I really like that. That's actually really fucking nice. The red.
Whoa.
I'm not concerned about that. Look at the fucking bike. Move. Fuck off. Look at the bike.
Can you put the bike stand down? Is the bike going to hold you both?
He's got strong legs, okay? He's got this. All right? He's a man. Look at him. I don't blame you, girl. I mean, I do because I'm straight, but you know what I mean. That's romantic as shit. I don't know why you did that, though. I don't know why you're just sitting on the motorcycle. You're wasting gas. It's really expensive in this economy. And two, you're like, I know you're wearing leather pants. That was a good decision. If not, you'd be burning the shit out of your legs on that gas, Gary, right now, on the fucking motor right now. It would hurt. This is, you got a third-degree burn on my dad's motorcycle when she was younger. Don't fuck around on it. It's not a toy. Fucking immature ass people. All right, I needed an excuse to pause it so we didn't get copyright blocked. There's no one's wearing helmets, by the way. I need to say that too. I can't tell if that's Prince, Steven Sanchez, or The Weeknd.
A mix.
It really does look like all three of them. You think I'm fucking with you. Alright.
Have we paused?
We're good. Just where I was waiting to pause it. Okay, it's neat so far. Nothing crazy. It's just kind of happening. Fuck, I know I'm congested. Everybody at work was telling me they're congested. Now I'm fucking congested, man. They infected me. Is this her family? I have a question, actually. Have you ever been on the beach at night?
Fuck yes.
It's the greatest thing ever. I haven't been since I was younger. I only imagine how much cooler it'd be if it were you with friends and not family.
No, I actually remember one time, what was it? Well, it was kind of. It was like me and my siblings and then a bunch of other people staying at like a holiday park, right? The holiday park was on the beach. And so, like, it got dark later on. It was the middle of the summer. And we just went out at, like, 11 o'clock and, like, had our own little campfire on the beach and shit.
I loved it whenever...
And the sand as well, and the beach as well, right?
Was that when you caught the shark?
One of the best beaches I've been on. Yeah, that's when someone caught the shark.
Oh, I remember that. I remember you sent me that video. That was like 2020.
Yeah, that was a long time ago. Hilarious.
It was cool. Yeah,
someone caught the shark, and then they grabbed it by the tail and slung it.
It's been so long. Yeah. It's so fucked up. I haven't been on the beach in like in such a long time, so I don't even like. I just remember it being so fucking peaceful. All right, let's go.
The kid came back confused. He was like,
I don't know if I want to do that. I like it. It's not like anything crazy. It's just like it is. It's kind of nice though. I can't say it's blowing me away, but you think of the first impressions we have of other artists, this is really good in comparison to most 90 fucking percent of the time. You know what I mean? This is like after what FKA Twigs just did to me, everything else is just like a breath of fresh air when it's not a ritual going on for 7 minutes. Like it's like a whoo, shit, 3 minutes, like cool, good. I like that part, the feel like home part. It sounds cool.
He's gonna fall off.
No, he's not. It's fucking gangster, baby. It's cool as shit. Oh, I see. This guy feels like home. I get it now. So she's with him, and she's imagining where I imagine where she's from. Or it's just some random fucking place she's showing for no reason. That would make no sense, but it's what I think's happening. It's a cool video concept.
Yeah.
Cool video concept, too. And a really good shot right here. Although, once again, like I said, it bothers me there's no helmets. You could have just set the helmet to beside. It's all fun and games till you fucking come out with a limp. All right. You didn't even skip it. I like this dude's hair. He reminds me of my cousin. I must say my cousin is mixed. Oh, who's this? Well, that's cool. Well, love memory of them.
Oh, in loving memory of someone. Oh, someone died.
Must have been someone she knows. Dylan, you're going to the deepest, darkest pits of hell for that smile you just did. You're a fucking cunt. It's not funny. We're not laughing at that.
You were smiling. You were happy. And I was like, it's so hard to say that because I realized it. I don't think you did. And you were like, oh, that's cool. And I was like, no.
You didn't hear me. I said, I said, oh, that's cool. And love and remember whoever that was. I didn't get to read it. Like, I was, that's cool. I didn't like. But then I look over and you go. it's like that picture of like where when it's like the face my bro makes. It's like the face bro makes whenever they say the teacher's saying one of the students has cancer or something. It's just this. It's like the. Like the laughing faces, it's like your friends make it impossible for you to not laugh at things you shouldn't laugh at. It's like every time someone says something super sad, you go like, "Let the games begin." It's like, bah, bah, bah. All right, no, but all jokes aside, that was actually really cool. I liked it.
No, it was really good.
It's a breath of fresh air.
Really calm, really nice little message.
I got it. Bart, you gotta move. Bart, you gotta have to move. You have to move, bud. Okay, all right. Congested. All right, next we
nice
got
stuff, Fushi.
Next we got Tate McRae. It's okay. I'm okay. So let's just go ahead and get this party started.
I'm starting to think she's not okay.
So I think, well,
I have a sneaking suspicion.
Three sisters, and a mom, which is dope. Kind of gay if I didn't.
This always pretty dope.
But it would be very gay if I didn't have one when you think about it. No, there's nothing wrong with being gay. I need to say that. In case there's any FK Twigs fans still back here, or any more Pale Waves fans back here, or any most of the artists are gay. Okay, Tate McRae. It's okay, I'm okay. In my experience, it's okay never means it's okay. It means there's a problem. It's like, it's no, I'm fine. It's like, but are you though? All right, let's go, Tate McRae. I'm sure this video is not going, you know, I'm not even going to start. I'm not going to speak into existence. Surely this
ass.
Yeah. I need to say something. He's not saying that. Hold on. You got to give context to these people, bud.
I'm not saying the song is ass. I'm just going to say we're going to see hers.
Okay. That sounds like such a pink thing to say, Dylan, and you don't even know it. You have to give context here, bud. The whole
what
video...
other context is there?
So when someone
there
clicks
is
on the video...
There's no more
so
context
I need
needed.
To, hold on, listen. So when someone clicks on the video, right? Also, QT, Brando. QT is fucking cold. I gained every ounce of respect right back. Anyway, you. Okay, I go to QT every day. Yeah, sorry. You. When someone doesn't know what's happening, and they click on a reaction to their artist they like, and all they hear is, we're gonna see your ass. It's like... You are so much of a fucking dick and a like a misogynist you sound like. They have no context that the whole video has been people who are basically naked.
Well,
and that's
what
why
do
we're
mean
making
to say?
The joke.
I don't want to see her ass. I want to see her put clothes on, and
well,
then you get related to the sexist.
Exactly, so, but I do want to...
So here's the thing. Here's the thing about reacting to females who get their ass out in videos. You're either sexist or you're sexist. There's no winning. You can't win.
All right, either way, I love Tate McRae's music.
All
let's
I can
go.
Do is smile through right, it, okay?
I'm excited for Tate McRae's new music, so let's see what we got going on. Let's see what we're doing this. QT brand deal. Get your money up, not your funny up. Fuck is you talking about? We're not at the beach. That was misleading. This is looks like the exact same set as Katy Perry had in the woman's. could be the same set.
Yep.
Yeah, well, that was quick. Wait. Did I saw it, right? You said... You fucking caught it! Oh my god! Hold on, I gotta tell you guys this. So I'm just gonna say this, right? So I have been like, how do I say this? Being responsible, basically doing November's challenge for a while now. And he made the joke. I was like, I don't know about all this. All this fucking nudity is going to be in this week. And I don't want to see it. And he was just like, what do you think? Tate McRae's just going to fucking pop her shirt off. Oh, you fucking called it. That's so hilarious. Oh my god, bro. Oh, this couldn't have gone any worse for me. Is this Face the Wall Edition Part 2? All right, come on. Come on, be a grown up. It couldn't have possibly... It couldn't have possibly gone any worse for me!
It could have. The censors couldn't be there.
Oh my god, bro. This is fucking bullshit, bro. I hate society. I'm gonna have to just look at that. Okay, we're back. Are we clothed again? Are we gonna pause it?
They wrapped the police thing around her just to make sure that...
Guys, this might be my toughest challenge yet. this might be my fucking, like, Mount Everest right now. Alright, let's go. The song's not good so far, by the way. I don't like this song at all so far. Not that I've had much ability to pay attention. You only get so much blood in the human body. just kidding. Oh, fuck, I'm kidding. Relax.
You remember that Coldplay album, A Rush of Blood to the Head?
Yeah.
A Rush of Blood to the Balls. Okay. You might want to pause it.
We were good. I paused it in a minute for like a solid 20 seconds. This is fucking... If I can if I can survive this video, then I shit you not, I think I will ascend to heaven immediately. I think I will be one of the fucking apostles at that point. I'm already cooler than Judas at that point. Judas was a fucking snitch. I've actually, over the course of this video, figured out something very important that's gonna help me with the future of this channel. If you look at the bottom left corner, your peripheral vision can still figure out what's happening without, like, seeing what's happening. So, stare at that pause button in the clock. Fuck, I need it back. Go back. Wait, where did I pause? Okay. She's doing the construction belt again, isn't she? No, it's not. Okay. I thought this was happening for a minute. I was like, are we doing it again? What are you, Olivia Rodrigo? Okay, we need... Okay, no, is there a better way to go back, forward? What do I do? Everywhere I go, there's ass! Oh, this video, this reaction alone has ended our career. It's just a wraps after this one. There's no right answer. You can't turn glorified porn on in front of me and expect me to be like, wow. I'm amazed by the talent. Like, I can't. I'm just like, why, man? Fuck!
Especially when the song is fucking garbage.
I just want to view you as a person. I mean, fuck. Is it that much to ask for? Can we just, like... Okay.
I presume she's talking about that ex, again, being like, oh, you can have him anyway. I'm done with him. Blah, 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 blah.
Yeah, I mean...
Just
stop. Let's just keep
like,
going.
Did you and Leroy have a challenge? Did you have a little bedroom challenge? Who can make the worst fucking song? I think you win.
Tape, yeah. I don't believe that. Unless it just took you a while to find that realization, which is fair. All right. Alright, we're not done. I just had to pause it.
See, it's like, at the start of the video, it's like, I was trying to think, why did she get arrested? And I remembered, oh right, public indecency. Forgot about that.
Alright, stop. Let's continue. Oh yeah, no, that is, yeah, exactly what happened. Are we just back to the beginning? Okay. This video gives me very much Sabrina Carpenter. Without the dancing. Mainly because she got arrested and was on the beach. Which is most of Sabrina Carpenter's very popular espresso video. What do I have to say? I think I fucking ended my career with that one. It's over. It's all over. You know, I don't, you know, I think it's over. I think I'm fucked. But from that point on, that is a video I will never see again, and a song I will never hear again. And yet a moment I will probably think about. Hold on. I love Tate McRae. I like so many of her songs, right? More than Dylan does here. But like I said, it's a video I'll never see again, a song I'll never hear again, but a moment that will probably replay in my head over the coming weeks.
The coming week.
No, there's no coming weeks, but the coming weeks, okay. the fourth happening weeks, okay, is the better word choice there. The next week, I think it's gonna torment me. I think it's gonna listen to the new single. It's Maya the choreography. You think Satan's PC? You think Satan's... Alright, well, I'm getting carried away. I'm too tired. I can't...
Oh, fuck no.
Okay, alright. Phineas Cleets. Fuck yeah, Phineas. Let's go.
Cleets! What the fuck is
that
name?
It's a cool name, actually. I like it. Oh, well, here we have Cleets immediately. Do you not know what Cleets are? Oh.
To me, it's just a funny word.
Oh, no. It's such a popular word for me. It's in, like, every sport. No, it's these.
Oh.
It's these shoes. Oh. They're, like, soccer and football, yeah.
Right, because football. To me, I have no idea. To me, I just see the word cleats.
No, that's what that is. Yeah, that's a weird word if you didn't know. All right, I'm sorry. I'm going to say this right now. He seems to be in a bedroom with two teenagers, and he opened the song with It's a Little Touch. All right. Who produced this song? Did he? He fucking did he? I mean, damn. It's a terrible start. There goes into the rest. Okay.
If it was produced with Diddy, his career is finished.
It bothers me that I know you thought about that for the entire time you were silent. You're like, finished. Watch this shit.
No, I thought about it like 2 seconds. No, the time I spent wasn't thinking about it.
All right, okay,
it
was thinking,
is it worth saying? Is it worth saying?
Let's stop. We start off. We carry the Tate McRae energy over to this song, so we gotta stop for a minute, okay? Different audience, different.
Are we gonna see Phineas's ass?
Everybody else has showed their ass in this fucking video.
Are we gonna see the Finney ass?
If I'm being honest, it probably would be the, like, least scarring one so far tonight. I would probably be like, look at that.
No, it turns out, right?
All right, stop. We gotta stop.
Randomly decides. Walk outside, bare ass cheeks.
I'm gonna restart the song because we've gotta stop. Okay, you might need to reset. Oh, you can even. Okay, we gotta stop. Okay, Siri, we gotta stop. All right, guys, sorry. I like that a lot. Quit smoking. Gatorade brand deal. It's a little touch and go. You could be the crutch that she holds. Got herself a sprained ankle. If you know, you know. Whoa, I don't like that. Felt like a very sexual innuendo. I don't know, I'm sorry. It could just be me.
How did she sprain her ankle, Mr. Finney? Bad things always come.
That's a fucking bar. Is this song about a lesbian who loves another girl and the girl's straight? If she plays for a different team, scraping her knees? A different team, scraping her knees? If you know, you know. I'm just saying. That's what it feels like to me immediately. Either way, if that is even remotely what it's saying, holy fuck, is that written well. Okay, fucking Chris Martin, what the fuck? Coldplay. Hell yeah. Boogie down, Phineas. Fuck I'm talking about. Maybe she's a late bloomer. Or maybe it's a fake rumor. But you've got the same sense of humor as her.
She's always at the wheel. You're often... I don't... Pause.
Yeah, I may have overgone. I got so distracted by the song. This one, I probably went over a minute on this one. I'm not sure, but I think I did. Either way, boohoo, figure it out. It's gonna be a rough one. You gotta edit it too. Can we get an RIP in the chat for Dylan? It's a small price to pay for what you got in the last video in the weekend.
Small
together.
Price to pay for Zach being oblivious.
I made a mistake, okay? I made God one mistake. Leave me alone, bro. Yeah, I'm still fucking replaying I'm still replaying what happened in the last video, okay? The last video is still in my mind right now, okay? I'm having to fucking
Fucking who?
Boo-hoo! Boo-hoo! Boo-hoo me! You don't have the fucking right to boo-hoo me, you bastard! We all know what's happening tonight and tomorrow, you fucker! You can't boo-hoo me! I'm gonna suffer! And you're going to heaven, you bastard! Don't you fucking boo-hoo me! You cunt! You selfish piece of shit! You'd be a fucking shame to yourself! Fuck you! I hope you have fun with the copyrights! You evil fuck! Sorry, Phineas.
Might need a stress relief.
Cool guitar, I like that.
I'm just waiting for the part of the video where Phineas shakes that ass.
He did earlier, you missed it. But you did, he really did.
No, he did this.
Which is what has been, every time Post Malone's ever done that, it is immediately fucking. I'm just saying, in his concerts, when he does that, when he does his dance moves, bro, I'm just saying, bro, 70% chance of rain. Stop fucking smoking.
They are definitely taking pills or something. No, I think she is a lesbian and... Yeah.
What?
I think you thought of it the wrong way around. I think she is a lesbian and she was... Like, this guy was
okay.
Like, oh, yeah, she's really
so, into me. Oh, so when she's like, okay, I see what's happening. Well, then why were her knees scraped because she's playing another team? Playing for the other team?
I don't know. Something's happened with scissoring? I don't fucking know.
I don't know. I don't know. I'm thinking... So, hold on. So, he's not... What do lesbians do? I don't know. They fucking... The way lesbians have intercourse is they fucking bump foreheads. I don't know. I missed that fucking day in school. They didn't teach me that part of procreation. I wonder why.
They don't have tops and bottoms. They have sides and ups. Sides and ups.
I get it is the worst part. Oh, fuck me. Oh, I see. Okay, I get it now. Fuck yeah. This beat is cold as fuck. It should definitely be in a movie. We agree? This needs to be in a movie at some point. This sound could be in a movie. Just the instrumentation. Nothing you can do either. Old crush on the new teacher. Wave as soon as you... I don't know where I paused last. I need to double check. I think I was good to play it out, right?
Yeah, I think you are now. I mean, you are
yeah,
now.
Yeah, now I'm good. Either.
Bleachers is a cool band.
They are.
Damn, bro, I got friend zoned.
That's fucked up. I mean, that's probably the best.
RIP in the chat.
RIP in the chat. That is probably the best way to get friend zoned, though, you know? Like, it's not that she didn't like you because you were a bad guy or anything. She just didn't like the fact that you were who you were.
She just didn't like the fact that you had a penis.
Which is where she drew the line. You know, maybe a small line, maybe a big line. Depends on the parameters of what she's drawing you next to.
I mean, either way, no, song's pretty good. Brilliant video.
It was a really cool fucking video. The instrumentation is fucking beautiful. The writing is great. The concept's beautiful. Everything about that was done super duper 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 well.
I don't know if we're getting a solo out of that. It was fucking hilarious.
Either way, but it was so... I don't know. Either way, I think we just do. I think we can.
Probably not.
Either way, I don't care if we do, but it was so good to me because it completely just... It made me forget about what I was put through right before it. But now it's back. Abel, I need you. Abel, Abel, I fucking
shake
need
that
you,
ass, Abel.
Abel, you need to rock my motherfucking world. In the famous
words
of Mike
Jack.
Wait,
hold on. Why
don't
we do the M&M stuff first? Why are we gonna do the Abel and then leave it with M&M?
I don't know. I don't know why I did that. Well, M&M sorry, Abel. M&M, it's up to you. I forgot M&M was here.
Right, so we're doing right now the expanded Mourners edition of the Death of Some Shady Coup de Grace. So we're starting with Steve Berman.
Steve Berman. I don't know who Steve Berman is. Isn't that a skit on the fucking Marshmallows LP too?
He's something like a publicist or something. He had a skit on like most of the. All right,
Steve Berman. Let's go.
Hi, it's Steve Berman from The Office. Apparently, Slim Shady has gone missing. Do I really care? If you happen to find him, do me a favor. Tell him to stay lost. What am I doing this for? Your call won't be returned because I really don't care if you find him or not. Now leave me alone.
Damn, what did you do to piss him off?
Steve.
You got
to go through his albums to understand Steve's piss off. Like, he started the Slim Shady LP, was like, I can't sell this record. Marshall Mathers LP was like, what the fuck is this garbage? Eminem show. I'm pretty sure he got killed, so I don't know why he's here.
He's back.
Oh, well, he's back.
Fucking FKA Twigs out here bringing motherfuckers back. First Daenerys or whatever. Fucking Daenerys. What's her name? Dolores. And then now we got fucking brought back Dolores, and now we're bringing back fucking Steve Berman. Brought back Pam Wade. I brought back everybody, when you think about it. This should be the
coming. Time for Fuel Shady Edition by Eminem featuring Westside Boogie and Grip.
I don't remember the original Fuel was the problem. So Fuel had. That was the one with.
J.I.D.
Yeah. So this isn't J.I.D. anymore. This is Westside Boogie and Grip.
Yeah.
Hold on, actually, to make this easier, so where we like can actually really, I'm gonna pull this up on Genius, so we can like actually properly analyze what's happening. Hold on, what was it? What was it called? It's Fuel Shady Edition, isn't it? Hold on, Fuel Shady. He has a vocal tone. I don't know either of these artists, but he immediately has a similar vocal tone to J.I.D. Immediately, so it or immediately doesn't like sound any too much like. Come see how heavy it get. I done seen way too much stress as a jit. Death in this section was present. We prepping for war, so we feel like we better equipped. Brody got demons he keep to himself. Probably won't ever know, cause he never gonna snitch. Hella resentment from letting it sit. I say I got him, I'm never gonna miss. I done put way too much prep into this. Back on your bumper, I'm wrecking this bitch. I keep on talking about healing, that's never gonna happen. You know that I'm stepping on shit. I say the feeling I get for me killing a rapper. Just show me that heaven exists. Shooting till ain't nothing left in the clip. Shooting till I get respect in this bitch. I might just go get a tech in this bitch. I might just go at the ref in this bitch. Guessing you think this shit new to me, huh? Guess you ain't know what's fueling me, huh? I just had any. Okay, first of all, I don't know who this is. Who did it say it was? Westside Boogie. He's fucking cold.
Yeah.
He's a good-ass rapper. This is nice. I like this a lot. Fuck yeah. We continue. Me shooting me, tell me just what could this industry do to me, huh? Helping the hood and the homies and plus the community think that it's tool me, huh? Know where I go when it's over, I run out of gas. They gon' say that they threw me, huh? Oh shit, when all this shit gon' get better? Bitches just fucking whoever. Niggas just saying whatever. Niggas gon' fold under pressure. Honestly, I ain't no better. I had to hop out the hole and got cold as a shoulder. I turned my emotions.
Here, I'm better with better.
I don't give a fuck. On my soul. I trying to be broken forever. I see the smoke and start running into it. Tiny, you losing it so thick. Is it as big of a deal if it's like four bars apart?
I mean, did he rhyme anything else in the line with it?
What do you mean?
Did he rhyme the syllables before it?
When all this shit gonna get better, honestly, I ain't no better. Yeah, kind of in a weird way. No, it's near rhyme.
No.
Like, it's near, but no, not. Shit gonna get better. I mean, to me, this is still better than the girl in the world. I kind of think that you wanted to happen. Got put in the corner, you forced me to do it. You got to tell me that being a rapper is hanging with rappers and I ain't into it. I'm with this shit and I'm ready to prove it. Waiting on Marshall to say I can do it. This shit going. I'm running out of fuel. I won't. What the fuck y'all going to do? If I don't. Running out of fuel. Running out of fuel. All right, so I don't remember Eminem's verse, by the way. So I'm interested to see if his verse is gonna still be here. He's gonna do it.
I mean,
one.
Fuel. I think Fuel was the best song on Death of Slim Shady by far.
It was the best one for him to do a different version. It says Shady Edition, so is it gonna be like an older verse or something on it, or is it just different people? I don't know. We'll find out in a minute. But
maybe
anyway,
just different feature verses. Either way, Eminem's verse on that was his best rap verse in ages.
Anyway,
so.
But anyway, this is Grip. Let's see what Grip's got going on. Never heard of him. Let's go.
Grippy.
It, for like half a second, it actually did sound like J. Cole. For like half a second, I was like, no. It's like, it's funny. All right. Sorry. Yeah. I was slapped on the left for dance. Went with them bled for a game that really kept me fed. They want to fade just a speck of crap. Nowadays, I take a check instead. Depend Ben steps ahead. If you mention him, them boys wet the bed. Get on the track with Grip and get knocked out like your daddy did. Whatever Debo said to Craig, we can go head to head. Niggas play hard on the app. And then mama crib hating on bars and a rap for niggas that still starving. The trap clap back in the script. You taking it too far. Just relax. These words are the scar on the wax. Shit deeper than the cars and the rats. The fashion and gas. And when the star and the rats got a son of a field nigga with scars on his back. Support. Okay. Either way, he picked good rappers.
Yeah.
He picked good fucking rappers for the song, though, to be fair. Where are we at? There's a lot of ass going on. Ass! Sorry. You guys... No, the song's not ass. It's just a lot of ass in this New Music Friday. Where was he at? Fuck, I don't know. All right, continue. Part of me feel an instant click, pitch a fit, blitz a bitch, blitz a shit, grip in the kitchen with instant grits, lick the wrist that wishy missy, 6 for 6. Go back to the discog, it's obvious, I'm the godliest, yeah, I'm sending y'all. I took a summer off just to let them get their mumbles off about blocks and things, spun it all. The uninvolved underdog, summer from a junker slumber, the pummel y'all, but they don't want to brawl. This shit ain't even fun no more. I mean, don't nobody want to come outside. They're like, you should do a song with so and so, or maybe such and such. This shit done, I tried. Then once I got it in the arsenal, I met a car, put a pick a pin up, and now ain't the man. But then again, I'm partial. It really took Marshall just for me to get a feature down. I know that's what I started with. But when you're talking markets, authority to the bar to spit, it's harder to put your heart in it. But come too far to quit. And I'm on the guitars and shit. So I had to. Holy fuck.
Okay.
This motherfucker is not fucking around. This motherfucker is not fucking around. I can't. I'm trying my hardest to keep up. Jesus. Okay. Let's go. Just for me to get a feature down. I know that's what I started with. But when you're talking markets, authority to the bar to spit, it's harder to put your heart in it. But come too far to quit. And I'm on the guitars and shit. So don't find a jarring if I switch the whole style up. Put the old grip, go get the old album. Any genre, same outcome. I want that bit with a stick like Malcolm.
He just said, I want to go buck. Screw down.
Okay, is Eminem have a new verse? What is the first line of his old verse? Do you remember?
For a couple decades, relentless tick spray.
Is that? Is this new verse?
No, we don't. It's the new verse.
I thought he was gonna do. He doesn't strike me as a person to not do a new verse. Cause I remember he did the one with what song was it that he did with Jack Harlow and Cordae?
Killer.
And he did a new verse, and it was a really good verse. So I wondered if that's.
Yeah, and also Chloroseptic as well with Fresher and 2 Chainz.
All right, well let's go.
Crazy, cause 2 Chainz is actually on. One of these.
Oh, that is crazy. All right, let's go. I was up to my waist in debt. Better yet, face and neck, trying to chase a check. Sweat labor for minimalist wages get. Just trying to get me a dub like a blank cassette. I worked for peanuts to the day I met Dre, and that gave me a little raisin neck. Not nothing is close to disgusting as what I roasted. This must mean that what I wrote me. Okay, I got to go back. Hold on.
First of all, what is the vocal production here? I don't.
It's the AI shit again. I don't like it at all. It should have just been. I don't like that. It should have just been him. It's the AI Slim Shady. That's why it's a shitty edition. That's what I thought they were gonna do. It's what happened a lot of way throughout the album. But no, it should just be his voice.
Yeah.
But I mean, I could get over it, but irrelevant. Yeah, cause I was up to my waist in debt. Better yet, face and neck, trying to chase a check. Sweat labor for minimalist wages get. Just trying to get me a dub like a blank cassette. I worked for peanuts to the day I met Dre, and that gave me a little raisin neck. Not nothing is close to disgusting as what I roasted. This must mean that what I wrote makes it a illest. Oh my god. Was ever will be. That's the real reason I still squeeze and I feel these bars with so much vitriol. These voices in my head convince me. I bet that Ted Kaczynski will feel me. Cause I see a read. You'll kill beasts like it's real keys. My peripheral sees everything to his POV. The bad G.O.D. from Lil C's. It's a fill arenas. I made it big with a Lil C's. Fill remix of who be picked next to. I'm sorry, there's so many bars. Yeah, Lil Caesar's Arena number one is right there. From Lil Caesar's to filled arenas. Oh my god. And you have, immediately you have, what is it again? Let's see. I worked for peanuts till the day I met Dre. Gave me a little raisinette. But that's nothing close to. Nothing is close to disgusting as what I grossed. Gross, disgusting. Oh my, it's just. It's.
Jesus.
His name's gonna be next up. Notorious B.I.G.'s death was the domino effects of Tupac's murder. Like facial tissue, whose clock should I clean next? Plus, still he's in police handcuffs. Guilty, will he step up? Like G never turned himself in. Who knows?
What is it with going after Diddy? He just...
just does. I mean, to be fair, I can't get mad at him because it's, if anybody deserves him. Trying to remember, so he is talking to G Dub, his bad boy artist who turned himself in for murder. Oh, so yeah, that was the dude who did it. Okay. I thought so. All right. So he didn't go after. Did he go after? No, he didn't go after, did he?
Puffs.
What did he say, Puffs? I missed it.
Yes. Like facial tissue, whose clock should I clean next? Puffs?
Oh, yeah, Kleenex. Like facial tissue. Oh, okay, well, that's right there. I was wondering where the other reference was. It was POVs, the bad GOD from Lil C's. It's a fill arenas. I made it big with a Lil C's. Lil remix of who be pick next. Whose name's gonna be next up? Notorious B.I.G.'s death was the domino effects of Tupac's murder. Like facial tissue, whose clock should I clean next? Plus, still he's in police handcuffs. Guilty, will he step up? Like G never turned himself in. Who knows all the murders they'll pin on me next? So prepare for me to not choose none of my words carefully. I've been comparable to Ivan the Terrible. I take a paraplegic and I slam his wheelchair on the cement. At physical therapy treatment, then laugh hysterically. These wimps, I like Slim's hair when he bleached it. Y'all need a light. Okay, we're assaulting the paraplegics, which is very unnecessary. I don't understand why we're doing that. That really kind of came out of nowhere. I don't know what that had to do with anything.
Stephen Hawking, shake some ass.
His wheelchair on the cement. Physical therapy treatment, then laugh hysterically.
These wimps, I like Slim's hair when he bleached it. Y'all need to. If K Twix, can you bring him back so he can shake some ass?
I don't. And then what? And then what? Is he gonna do? Type it?
I am currently shaking my ass.
Let's continue.
His ass. I spit bars so barbarically, a fucking parakeet wouldn't dare repeat. I'll
never be running out of steam or kerosene if I run out of fuel. He said, I spit bars so barbarically, a fucking parakeet wouldn't dare repeat. Did he have the best verse? I really liked his verse, but the dude right before him.
Yeah, no, I think Grip probably did.
There's some debate there to be had, because the punchlines were really good, but...
Yeah, I think Grip had the best verse, but, and also, I don't think Eminem's verse... I don't think any of the verses actually are as good as either of the verses on the
we're
original
not gonna
Fuel.
Yeah.
Nor do I think this is as good as the original Fuel, obviously.
I do like it, though. It was good.
Production... It's actually got... They changed up the production a bit. And it's kind of weaker, actually, to be honest. It's still fine. But, I mean, yes, yeah, nothing compared to the original Fuel. So, yeah.
Yeah. Let's do, I guess next is Like My Shit. So let's go ahead and do that.
Shit comes out your ass!
Shh.
Yo. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay,
easily.
DA's on this.
One of the best, one of the, you know, you got one of the better producers, and almost everybody's one of everybody's favorite producer tags. What is the first song that comes to mind? D.A. got that dope. Three come to mind for me immediately. One, There's No Regrets. D.A. got that dope. Screaming out, no regrets. And you got D.A. got that dope. These say these bars are like COVID. You get them right off the bat. Two Eminem songs. And then the other one that comes to mind first is D.A. got that dope. And it's PTSD with Juice WRLD and G Herbo. And Chance the Rapper and... Uzi, yeah. Who, by the way, all had some of their best verses. That's, Chance the Rapper had an insane verse.
My dad died. Oh, still on my bad side.
That was so out of nowhere.
Oh, because you'd already played the intro, and then you just pulled... the second you played it, my dad died.
Yeah, let's go.
Yo. Yeah. My dad died. Still on my bad side. That's how I know that I'm back on my shit. Cause I'm that fly. Call me the Titanic. I've been known to fuck up entire crews. Treat your click like trying on fitted hats. I'm capsizing you. Like a waiter do with a tray of food. Haters, you cater to them. I talk my shit, but I back it up.
take the hate and I make it fuel. Nothing else left to say or do. Got dessert, a fork, plate, and spoon. Must put my money where my mouth is, cause I got my cake and I ate it too. Ate it bitch. But
they bite off of this cause they like my shit. No fucks, take offense.
Okay, he was not listed on this. They fucking did him dirty. They did not list him on Spotify. 15 after. It's a cool name. Is that Josh Giddey's rap name?
No, it's actually it's actually like talking about the like this boy, right? He was 14.
No, song's going, we're going.
And
no,
spent a year with him.
Elite songwriting. Okay, not a good chorus immediately.
Yeah. Not as good as an understatement. That's fucking terrible.
That's not it. That's not it. Yeah, I don't know what we're doing. The song, actually, I made a joke because of the beat. Does it not sound like... It actually reminds me of Nat, ironically enough, the way he's rapping. I know I just made the... It reminds me of Nat.
Television, and the one you have is cheap. It's like when they test your blood, that shit is a plasma screen. My house is like Alfred E. Newman, bitch, I got mad TVs. I got a whole lot of issues, mad magazines. Turn the thermostat all the way up, it's the only way you're gonna blast the heat. Are you leisure wear like V-necks, all y'all just casualties. Critics, I don't rap to please. They be like that brand of greens, label them Del Monte. Cause everyone you can appease.
That's a fucking bar.
The casualties was a bar.
Yeah, Del Monte. Del Monte is the most popular fucking brand for like canned vegetables. So they said label them Del Monte cuz everyone you can't appease. It's a bar. A lot of bars. I will say though. The one thing I will say about Eminem real quick, cuz we've been pretty high on everything, and this is a much better verse than the first one. I think Eminem, and this is a bold statement. I usually don't say stuff about Eminem here. I think Eminem sometimes gets a little carried away with punchlines. I know people sometimes say, "What? What? What do you mean?" What? I think it feels like everything is a punchline or a punchline setup. You know what I mean? It feels like a bunch of one-liners. They almost sometimes don't feel like they connect too much. Sometimes that gets taken away, and it feels like I would like to hear an Eminem song where, yeah, there can be punchlines, but I'd like to see him just rap. I like to see, okay, can he keep me entertained for a whole song without, well, really just saying stuff, but like without it being like a bunch of one-liners. So no fucks, take offense, but you like that shit.
Yeah. Skip the chorus, dude.
Yeah,
this
I was about
fucking
to say
it's terrible.
It is not it. Okay. Alright, okay, we got Eminem verse. Eminem's doing good. Holy fuck, this is a long verse. This is like you wrote a song. This reminds me of your verse on our Toby remix, which is on our channel. Go check it out, as well as our Houdini remix. They're both linked below. Probably you should link them below. It's a New Music Friday, so you're not linking them below.
They are linked below.
Oh, they are linked below. Yay! Yay.
In a world that never really gave a crap about me. 2 months my dad was out, he blew up, he bragged about me. Talk about season in the moment, it's like I had the Lowry's. I got jumped at checkers, but across the board the game had to crown me. Man, I swear this shit is a trip, similar to a family outing. When I look back at how these kids in my class would clown me, said I'm just a huge waste. Well, that must make these rappers bumpy, cause now they all feel so small that they won't even rap around me. Expect me to get...
There's bars, but... I don't know. I'm not feeling the song, though, even though the bars are good. Does that make sense? I don't like the sound. I don't like the style of it. I don't like the style of it.
In like a sinkhole, stinkhole, bitch, no, I don't think so. Like Cool J back to Cali, borderline, but I have no boundaries. You get in my way, I'm a barrier, like a barricade around this area. They call me the Grand Canalby, because I'll be damned if rap ain't damn, but I keep it a grand like a damn finale. Coup de grace as I shot the superstardom. Who'd have thought with my medulla oblongata screwed up thoughts could do the toddlers, but I grew up on ramen noodles. Combination of post-trauma due to mama. Got me off my rock, a human llama, but everything is not Hakuna Matata. But I pour my heart into the ink in these letters. I tell you what part is I piece it together. How am I so sick if I keep getting better? Bitch, you ain't fucking with me if this ever. You got no cheese and no cheddar. You need some yeast, at least get your bread up. I hit your bitch up like Pac. Told her to please keep her head up.
Didn't he get shot in the car? And didn't someone say the person in the car said that they told him to keep his head up? Am I tripping? Is that what he referenced? Wait, hold on. Oh, his song? Okay, I heard something about that, too. It must have been somebody else. There was somebody else who got shot, and they were telling him to keep their head up. So I thought that's what he was saying, and I was like, there's no fucking way he just said that. Okay, good. I will say, like, you might disagree, but some of the rhyme schemes here were actually really, really good.
No, they were insane rhyme schemes, but then again, Eminem does not, just doesn't not have insane rhyme schemes.
Yeah, but, like, that's, impossible. Like, that's levels, though, is what I mean. Like, that's really, really good right there. Look at him with time to rhyme it. That was really good.
You need some yeast, at least get your bread up. I hit your bitch up like Pac, told her to please keep her head up, head up, head up. Cause she was sucking my dick in the Jeep when we met up. I show up like you just said, speaking yeah. The devil is speaking. Now shut up, now shut up. Shh. I'm trying to take rappers heads off. I'm out for blood like the Red Cross. Turn your GPS off and get lost. This tech is not for no TED talk. But every word that come from my lip bomb like arm chapstick. See, because the motherfucking compact is bomb back.
Holy ahead of my time. Fuck, relax. Like, every time I'm like, oh, that's a bar, another one happens. He said, I'm out for blood.
He didn't have a fast verse on the album, so this is the fast verse. He was like, shit, I didn't have a fast verse.
He said, I'm out. He said, I'm out for blood like the Red Cross. That's a fucking bar. It's a double bar. When you think about it, Red Cross, they take blood. I don't know if you know this, right? Red Cross, is they take blood.
Yeah.
And it's also, Red Cross is also, like I said, it's Red Cross is the company. Okay, it's also for hospitals who take blood, which is the same thing there. But also, a scope is also often a Red Cross. So it's kind of weird. But also the chapstick lip balm. Oh my God. On my watch fast, bitch. I'm strapped safety off that bitch. Cock back with this paper mate. The pin will be the only thing I'm not capping. Put it with your goddamn jaw jacket. Used to write my raps on napkins. Too much paper now I'm stacking. You can't take it like too many napkins. Alcohol, but I'm strong as it. If rap is liquor, this song has it. Yeah. So if you don't want to get wasted, these ain't the kind of bars that you want to take shots at, then they
buy it off of this. Alright, song's done.
Yeah, great song.
Song's done.
Everything Eminem did was really good, though. So that's probably the best. Like, I don't.
Well, okay.
I didn't
really
like the
good.
It really got better
maybe
throughout.
An overstatement.
First verse,
the first
not a huge
verse
fan.
Was kind of eh.
Second verse was better.
Okay.
It felt like a bunch. It felt like if third you were reading. Verse, it, good, it felt like a bunch of one-liners. But, the third verse was really good, but the second verse felt like, the second verse felt like if like I went on a Google Doc and I just wrote a bunch of punchline ideas ahead and you just read them down the list. But anyway, we'll move on. I
didn't
like
it. Yeah, I mean,
the
chorus was fucking ass. To me, the song is kind of like, eh. Because, like, I think Eminem good. The other guy, it's probably Lean's bad, to be honest, because Eminem didn't really blow me away. It's,
also, once again, like, Friday the 13th.
And the chorus was pretty fucking ass. So, yeah.
I do want to get that shirt, though. See it? It's a cool shirt.
Anyway, now for the final one.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, that's a cold ass jam. How much is that? Sorry, I got distracted. I got to check out the sales price. It's like, that's cold as fuck, though. You got to be honest. That's cold as fuck. But it's got to be a little gay. So I can't. Kyrie and Luca, if you need context, Kyrie and Luca are who ruined my life. Luca is my most hated person on this planet. Kyrie and Luca are. Kyrie Irving and Luka Doncic, both star players for the Dallas Mavericks of the NBA. I am a Oklahoma City Thunder fan. I have an NBA logo on my head, as you can see here. And if anybody knows anything about basketball, which I assume probably a lot of you do, then you know why I'm upset, because they ended our season last year. They molested us in the playoffs.
So, wow.
I'm not happy with them. I love Kyrie. I don't love Luka. I said what I said. Bitch, I said what I said. Well, and I'm going to hell. This reminds me of hate. I'm not going to hell. It's a joke, guys. In case you didn't know.
Yo, 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 kid. D-Town. What up, yo? Tony.
Okay. Standing on. Okay, I'm going to pause it. Bart, you quit it. Bart, quit it. Bart's about to shit off of the top of the closet. Quit it. Quit it. Ah, sorry. It's in the script. Sorry. Speaker, tall as Burj Khalifa, powder on the plate to turn the girl into Eureka. Remember, if I don't see it, then I don't believe it. I done some pretty dumb things on the tequila. Birthday in Vegas, laying with my Weezy. Asked about a friend, she like, boy, I don't believe you. I'm just trying to live, and they turned it to evil. My partner is a grip, the only thing he eat is seafood. School of hard knocks, I can fuck around and teach you. License to kill, and I just got him renewed. Spoke to Def Jam, and they talking about a Reno. Spoke to God's here, and he can pay me. Am I even guys? Is that even guys? Is that because there's no blood in... Oh, see. Okay.
Oh.
Oh, I get it now. Okay, I thought it was because there's... Okay.
Yard Club, yeah, I'm Ricky Steamboat. Hey, you know my Bible, mixing mine with the Pino. I say scratch that, gonna bring it back.
This is a really unique beat.
I say scratch that, gonna bring it back like Primo. You know my set, I'm throwing dollar signs. I lick a neck and turn a body to a water slide. I'm in the bottom of my bag like some hot fries. Tony, that my top eye. Shit, you know why me swag on this beat? Enough to make Rakim proud of me. You got my map and your bitch ass post something negative. You could have called me. I'm from the dark side, but the whip light skin. I do what I want to do like white men. I
what?
Hit you in the fucking head with the mic stand.
Yeah, that's true. We do what we want. No. If this feels like a freestyle. Am I tripping?
Kind of.
Because it kind of slows down for a minute.
Daytime on a nightstand, you know that, did you? Real recognized, real, and you don't look familiar. I'm from Riverdale Road, we ain't got no river. Got the pole concealed behind the partition. Listen, a trap nigga, I'll perform at Bar Mitzvah. A trap nigga, I'll perform at the Crystals. I ain't gonna fight, but I still told pistol. I ain't gonna kill you. All I got to do is whistle. Damn, I think my roof's off. They've been plagiarizing, they've been stealing songs. Soon as I see him, I'ma pick him off. I got a beard, but I must ask Ricky Ross. God took his time with
me. Was that Rick Ross's ad, or did he just do a good impression? That sounded an awful lot.
Kingpins wanna sign with me. Gunshots is truly Atlanta. Well, things that go left like Julius Randle. I got the shit lit, no need for a counter. Just like Kyrie, I got the shit handled.
His handles, yeah, okay, whatever. Yeah.
Like Kyrie, I got this shit happening.
Okay, immediately.
So evidently, 2 Chainz is Kyrie and Eminem is Luka.
Yeah, because Kyrie's black and Luka's white, I imagine. And they're a really good duo. They're like a really fucking good duo. So what is he gonna, like, okay. Immediately, I did not like 2 Chainz verse. It sounded like, like I said, someone's talk freestyling. He's just kind of saying things. But it also... I'm gonna say something. 2 Chainz now kind of sounds like Uncle Ruckus, right? Like rapping. I like the sound of it, but I didn't like a lot of what was. I don't know. It sounded really weird. There was no consistent flow. He was just repeating things. I don't know. Good for you, that's fine.
Like Kyrie,
beat switch.
I got this shit out.
Walking around your party like where the party at? Yeah, Bacardi and yak could lead to a cardiac. But I'm drunk and I give a fuck like how cardiac. I'm already back, I just had to run to my cardiac. Headache and the leave, I'm gonna need 8 of them.
He did exactly, dude, he did what I did.
What?
The take a few syllables that sound the same and just do them constantly, like 4 times.
Yeah. Yeah, cardiac. It's 3 times, but yeah.
I did that on my Toby remix. Go check that out in the description below.
He was talking about something about Millie Bobby Brown and being a minor and how he was like Drake. That's all I remember hearing. But
no, that is not at all. That is completely not what
Formally
I said
B,
at
Formally
all.
B. I remember it. Anyway, I'm just kidding, guys.
Yeah, headache and the leave. I'm gonna need 8 of them. For Pete's sake, I've been stepping on leaf breaks again. I keep waking up in the bed with complete strangers and I eat praises and get more chicks than Pete Davidson. Man, I can't help it. I mean, I got the devil in me. Let me put it more delicately. Fuck your feelings. I'm a felon pussy. You're jealous of me. Probably because my cerebellum's a parabellum pussy. Even if I swear to sell a pussy, I'd still be like a female that's hooking. And shit you can do to stop me from selling pussy. Yeah, work mine.
I feel like we could have done better than that.
Yeah, no, that was a bit of a shit.
It's a bit of, it was a bit of a weird one. I'm not.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess it doesn't really matter
selling
at this point.
Pussy?
You can't expect him to be like the great. Well, he said he'd still be like a hooker. He said even if I swear to celibacy, I'd still be like a female that's hooking. Well, I guess I thought hooking didn't make sense, but hooking does make sense. She could do stuff from selling pussy. I mean, I don't really care. I can't expect every line to be great.
Your rhymes are so fucking washed up. I call them shorelines.
But as long as a 9-year-old's mind is washable, I'ma search till I find the most awfulest line as possible. Mind is off, all I need is a small little pint of vodka to be talked into trying to walk up inside of a Shriners hospital. And they're trying to make Marshall the guy responsible for little Joshua's giant arsenal. Like I'm also the reason his nine is cocked and he brought his tool and decides to hide it inside of his locker till the next time he's picked on us.
He releases the week after one of the most popular shootings ever happens in America. I don't think that was a good idea. I don't think that was a great idea. Anyway, I can, we'll play it out from here, I think. You'll run out.
Until the next time he's picked on at school. But you're out of your gourd if you're thinking that I ain't killing this beat. I'm not even forcing myself to vomit. But if I had a fucking eating disorder or anorexia, believe me, I couldn't body this more for you. Yeah. Man, I'm beyond childish.
Bar.
When I'm on volumes,
body dysmorphia. It took me
body dysmorphia.
It took me a minute to get it. That is such a long setup, too, though. It is such a long... That's a long setup for that line.
Anorexia, believe me, I couldn't body dysmorphia.
Bulimia! He said bulimia.
Oh, wait.
Fucking eating disorder or anorexia, believe me, I couldn't...
Oh, he said bulimia. Bulimia, which is making yourself throw up. Oh,
bulimia, couldn't body dysmorphia. Oh.
I'm not even forcing myself to vomit, but if I had a fucking eating disorder or anorexia, bulimia, believe me, bulimia, couldn't body dysmorphia. Oh my, that's got to be one of the best ones I've ever heard. That's insane.
Yikes.
That's a fucking bar.
Body dysmorphia. Yeah. Man, I'm beyond childish. When I'm on volumes, just like mom downs them, they call it Munchausen. Cause she hands me some, says, come on, chow some. These are non-drowsy. I mean, non-drowsy, but to help you calm down some. So before I song out him, trying to make Rob proud him, hoping this song rouse him. I pop like 9,000. I'm outie 5,000. Oh, hold up. One more thing.
What song did he say I'm outie 5,000? Oh, there's more. He said, oh, there's more. The beats are turning. He came back in.
I'm out of 5,000. Oh, hold up. Spit syllables on a mic in a booth like I'm a Jews. Even if I
wouldn't. Here it is.
Even my interviews get like 5 million views. I get accused of misogyny because I will misogyny. It's just like a masseuse mixing knife on the booze. Heineken Bruce hiding inside of my shoes. That's like I'm just playing fucking mumble rap. The coup de grace.
Fucking. Okay, he said, hold on, let's go back. Spit syllables on the rat, I mean, on the mic in the booth, like I'm at Drew's. Even if I win or lose, I'm in the news. Even my interviews get like 5 million views. And I get accused of misogyny because, fuck me, get this out of my face. Misogyny because I will massage any bitch just like a masseuse. Mixing NyQuil and booze, Heineken brews, hide them inside of my shoes. Okay, yeah, so he's saying like he's... Yeah, obviously doing drugs. I don't know about talking about massaging women and then talking about mixing NyQuil into a drink. I don't. It's a little too close together for those two lines. But I get what we're going for. Immediately, what am I thinking? I think
Eminem's acting like Bill, and I don't know what the cause be.
If I'm being honest, the last verse on "Like My Shit" and that and his verse on Kyrie and Luke are some of my favorite verses on the whole album. Just those last two, like his last verse on "Like My Shit," specifically Kyrie and Luke's verse. So, I'm not, if I'm going to give it a solid, like,
Bart, quit. Bart just, Bart, you did not. Bart, quit! God.
I mean, honestly, that's probably the best of the three. Like, as I said, like, I mean, it's good. But, I mean, there were definitely weak points in both of their verses. I don't think, like, you know, I mean, 2 Chainz, I haven't really heard too much 2 Chainz, so I can't really speak too much on him. But as far as Eminem goes, I mean, it's a great Eminem verse.
It is.
So, you know, but, he did have a weak punchline or two in there. 2 Chainz...
2 Chainz has, like, my favorite fucking sound
ever. It was a little basic at some point.
2 Chainz has my favorite rap song ever. 2 Chainz!
That's how you know he's there, but he just fucking screams it like this, like the funny, like the special kid in the classroom. That's fucking.
Yeah, so it's alright.
Yeah, it's alright. Anyway, Abel, Eminem and Phineas have done a great job at clearing my mind.
Oh wait, should we do a solo? What we should do for the Eminem one. I think we should
just do the deluxe as one video. Yeah,
Just do the deluxe as one video. Alright,
if you guys like this video, leave a like on this video, comment on this video, make sure to go check out our remixes. Let us know what your favorite song
is
the deluxe.
Toby.
Was. Yeah. Let us know what your favorite song that Deluxe is. As well.
Actually, that's a question. Let us know. Houdini remix from us, Toby remix from us, or Fuel remix from them.
Which is better, yeah. What do you think? Yeah. I think we know their answers, but if you would do me a favor.
Yeah, it's half a bag of Viagra, of course it is.
Check it out.
Yes, a bag of Viagra. From Olympic.
You did my part. Fuck you. I'm just kidding. But if you guys go check that out, make sure you subscribe. We're so close to 1,000. We appreciate it. We love you. Dylan, that's where you say goodbye. I think it's where you say goodbye. Sorry.
Goodbye. Bye, fellas.
I have to pee.
Ass!
I have to pee so bad. I need you to entertain. I need to pee because this is the last song, and I can't have to pee while listening to this song. I waited years. Years, I tell you.
Okay.
Tell them. So, explain to them our journey with The Weeknd.
I am. So our journey with The Weeknd. So one time, me and Zach just met The Weeknd randomly at a bar, and we just said, "Hey, The Weeknd, we should go on a road trip together." So our journey with The Weeknd started in Halifax. I think we started there. We got in a car, and then we just drove off. We started going. I think we went to like North Dakota or something, and then we got bored within like 5 minutes. There was nothing to do there. So we went to South Dakota, the better Dakota, and, you know, we saw a mountain with a few heads on it, and we were like, okay, that's cool. And then we moved on, and then, like, after that, we decided to get on a plane, and we flew to the Bahamas, and then we, like, swam a little bit, got a little bored. And then we went off to Africa, you know, we frolicked around in fields with gazelles. That was pretty cool. After that, we decided to then go off to Nepal, and then we hiked Mount Everest together with him. And, you know, he was a pretty cool dude. He helped us up there a little bit. Like, whenever we got cold, he'd give us a little hug, keep us warm so we didn't, like, die of hypothermia. Then once we came back down, you know, we rode a few goats back into Kathmandu. Then we flew off to Japan, you know, went and had some sushi at a local bar. Then we flew out to Australia, went bunny hopping on kangaroos. It was pretty fun. Then once we all got back home, The Weeknd then decided to start a music career. All
right.
And once he started his music career, we then got into his music over time. We didn't really like care too much about. We heard his pop songs.
Did you just now start on the music?
In 2020, I was telling you about the journey we had with The Weeknd. You'll see it in the final product of the video. Anyway.
No, I won't.
So then, yeah, we kind of like looked over After Hours when it first came out, but then like a year later, or not even a year later, it was like sort of late 2020, we then came back to it and went, oh shit, we really love this album.
Yeah, it became my favorite.
And then, you know, Super Bowl happened, we loved that, and then he became like one of our favorite artists through the next couple of years. Dawn FM came out in 2022, we didn't listen to it for a week because we were scared it wouldn't be as good as After Hours.
Oh shit, no.
Listened to it, really loved that as well. A year later, he then had the Idol soundtrack, and the Idol, we watched an episode of the show, there were a lot of pauses, we had to agree to watch it on our own after that, then, you know, we didn't really like many of the songs off of that soundtrack, but then we were worried about where he'd go with this, so he's been doing his tour, did a little, Sao Paulo performance, announced the album cover and the album title, Hurry Up Tomorrow. And this is the first single, Dancing in the Flames. So we're pretty excited. I hope that ramble.
This also perfectly. This also. I've done a good job. We've gotten an album in February and March. So because of the timing of this one, I have a feeling we're going to get it.
It was January.
It was January and March. So I have a feeling either one, we're going to get it in November, or two, we're going to get it next year. So either way, I mean, I'm not going to complain. The rollout has started. I don't want to have a situation where we're like, fuck, man.
Based on the timing of Dawn FM, he released Take My Breath in like August, and Dawn FM came in January. So if I had to guess, it'll probably be the start of the year.
All right, guys. Sorry. All right, back to what we were saying.
Cool.
We've had a great journey with The Weeknd. I think the album. As he was saying right before, he was rudely interrupted by the whatever the fuck happened to him. Has it just happened again? It happened again for a second on my end. You fucking froze for like 6 seconds. We have like a 5 second delay right now, but we'll run with it. All right, The Weeknd, Dancing in the Flames. I don't even know. I don't even want to do it. I don't even want to hit play. You know what I mean? It's like I don't even want to, like, you know what I mean? Do you feel me? You feeling me? Are you feeling me now, Mr. Krabs? You ready?
Oh, shit. Dude, it's lagging.
The Weeknd, Dancing in the Flames. I really don't want to hit play because, like, Also, it's 420. Exactly. Anyway. I'm scared to hit play. Like, it's almost, like, so long, I don't even want it to happen. You know? All right, we'll just hit play. Sorry. Like a fucking kid on Christmas. Bro's in the Upside Down. Oh, I like how this sounds so much already. I hope you make it, cause I've been chasing another odyssey. Okay. Phil Collins drums, okay, I hear him coming. What do you think so far? I have to pause it for copyright. I love the way it sounds, by the way. It's really quiet, though,
for some like, the melody sounds really weird over the beat. Is that just me?
No, I like it. The melody is really good. The melody's what kicking me. It's like, holy fuck, I like it a lot. It sounds pretty.
Maybe screen share is just giving me shit.
The audio is also kind of weird in the video. Like, it's really quiet. This is gonna be one of those that's a grower. And what I mean by that is, like, I feel like right now it's gonna be like, okay, I just feel like in like a week or two I'm gonna really like this song.
Like, the lead singles of both the last two albums have been massive growers.
This, you know, it's like, imagine the first time I was creeping. Well, I was like, there's a lot of elements I can tell I'm gonna like, but I just don't feel it yet. But I'm like, this is gonna be like one of my favorite songs very soon, I can already tell you. Yes, I'm glazing. Not again. Meow. Oh, the iconic hey, right? Hey! Yeah. Can't go wrong. This is very interesting, though. I will say this is not what I had in the cards for what I thought it might sound like. This is different.
This is similar to what I was expecting.
It does feel like there's elements of the idol. Not many, but elements. Like, I could see maybe some of the 90s influence now. That I didn't see, that wasn't in the other albums. The song is quiet because all the sounds, that is what it is. Who do you think produced this?
Probably Elangelo, Mike Dean.
That's what I'm thinking. It's not Metro.
I think Mike Dean.
There's no producer tag.
Yeah, but Mike Dean was rumored to be on the album with them anyway, working on. I think there was rumors that Mike Dean, Metro Boomin, and Elangelo were all definitely producing something on this album. So,
plot twist. Yeah. It's fucking. I don't know who's a crazy ass producer. Plot twist, it's fucking DJ Khaled. The whole second last minute of the song is just him talking about fucking Pringles cans. Okay, this is spoiling it. That's the thing that was on the cover for the tour, right? Okay, so just have faith, just have faith. This is a different message than usual, though. Too. Kind of. It's all very different. Even the video. It's brighter than usual. But like, it's not like flashy. It's like you have the red every once in a while, like After Hours, and all the blue dark tones like Don FM. It's like kind of blending them. Yep. Like video-wise. And audibly, you could say. There's some... It feels like these last three albums, honestly. Blended. I'm going to pause it so I can play it out, but this just... I was thinking about this the other day while I was walking. Hear me out. You tell me what you think. Bruno Mars and The Weeknd song. I think it would be a banger. I think they're a perfect combination. I never thought of it before. Like, I was walking, I was like, what's a combination that could have? I was like, oh, The Weeknd and Bruno Mars. That's number one, though, right? Surely. It's got to be. There's no way this doesn't go number one.
They can Maybe. I mean.
It's a massive star power.
You say that like Post Malone and Weeknd didn't go number one. Lady Gaga and
that was different. That wasn't the same thing. That wasn't the same thing though. That's different. Well, that's a little also different because it's like, okay, Lady Gaga isn't doing it right now. She used to do it, so it's like it's. You know. But Bruno's not doing it right now either. He's done it for a few years, so yeah, I don't know. Who knows? Neither is Abel. You brand of a light, shot in an iPhone 6. Damn, really? Fuck. Okay. An ambulance. And he said faith so many times. Flashing sirens and the flashing lights in the distance. That's funny. I wonder if that was intentional. Is this maybe like a spiritual replay of what happened in After Hours? Because he got in the car crash. Right? He was in the back of an ambulance. He's talking about faith. He said, you just gotta have faith, gotta have faith, gotta have faith. So my thing is like, okay, then what does this all mean? That's I think it's a conversation for another day. All right. But what I will say is immediately, video was great, by the way. It was a good-ass video. So we don't have to say that. But song, what do we think about the song?
No, I think the song was great. I think, really? Like...
Same.
Like, love the melodies there, especially the post-chorus there. The writing was pretty good. I feel like... As far as, like, the narrative goes, I think we do have to just wait for the album for that. I think we'd be wasting our time sitting around speculating on just a single. Yeah. Especially given that the whole thing is obviously meant to be a huge project. So, yeah, overall, I really liked it. It's definitely got my hopes up for the album, especially because hearing that Playboi Carti was on it was not nice news. It was kind of disappointing to hear. I was like, okay, let's hope he gives the performance of his fucking life.
It's like
life.
We're almost guaranteed there's a skip. Almost guaranteed there's a skip, which there has.
Which is annoying if there is, because like After Hours and Dawn FM were both no skip albums. So
if there's, it's like one song. Watch this album be better than both of those albums, but there's just one Playboi Carti song on it. Oh, that would fucking enrage me. All right. Let's we said enough. I know it didn't seem like we did, but we did. We're super excited. We'll see you guys for the next weekend single, obviously. You don't have to tell us twice. It's doing pretty well right now. It looks like it's doing very well, actually. Kind of. It's doing all right. It's streams is another question. I don't know how it's doing stream-wise, but it's doing pretty decently on YouTube. Nothing crazy.
That's not much at all, actually, for the weekend.
Yeah, I was about to say that. It sounded like it was much, because I thought this was Thursday night. Like, we usually do a single on release, but it's the NMF, so I was like, I thought this was, like, in, like, a few hours. But no, said not doing that well, but it'll pick up. It always does. At a time started that way, too. It didn't have a lot of views, and then it fucking popped. I remember seeing that. So it could. Either way, let's go best and worst.
Solo video.
Yeah. Okay. It's hard for me to keep up with them because, like, we'll do one, you're like, I keep forgetting, so this one I didn't think about it. All right. It doesn't matter. Either way, guys, if you guys want to know what I'm talking about, it means you should go check out our series, our New Music Friday series that we're doing. This is where this was recorded. So go check those out and see all of other reactions to artists that you might like. Just go look through them. If you guys like this video, leave a like, comment on the video, and let us know what you thought about the song and the video and things you may have picked up on that we didn't. Subscribe. I think I may have already said that. I don't know. But we're almost to 1,000, so I can say it 55 times. Subscribe. Yeah, I think that's about it. Did I forget anything?
Houdini and Toby remixes. I guess we're still promoting them.
We kind of stopped. Below. We only really promoted them for the week for the Eminem one. I was the only reason I brought him back. If you guys, yeah, Dylan, this is where you say goodbye. I think.
Still run him up anyway. Toby is still dead, lying on the floor. Goodbye.
Bye, fellas. All right. Okay, I left again a little bit of a pause there.
Right.
Alrighty. Best and worst. Let me go first. I'm just going to go first entirely. Because I think the last two times I let you go first, basically entirely, because I went the first few times before that. Okay. Worst. I'm just going to remind myself. Worst is a big fat fucking tie between both of the naked women this week. Katy Perry and Tate McRae. And best of the week is... You know, I really hate doing this, but it's. I'm actually going to do something. This I could regret this, or I could not. I think I'm going to give a tie for Shawn Mendes in The Weeknd, but I think The Weeknd's probably better. I think in, like, a day I'm going to regret that decision. But there's other... And Phineas has made a great song, too. The Weeknd's the best. Shawn Mendes and Phineas are honorable mentions. I'm done now. I'll shut up.
Yeah, worst, I mean... The outright worst is hands down Katy Perry and Doechii. That song was just so fucking atrocious. Like, it makes Woman's World look listenable.
Yeah.
In comparison. I'm still giving a dishonorable though to Tate McRae, because that was also fucking terrible.
As you should.
Nothing else really came close. Best of the week. There were some good ones this week. I'm probably going to have to give it to The Weeknd, because I did really like everything going on there, and I know damn well it will be better in the context of the album, so I'm just going to give it to The Weeknd to save any regret later. But then again, honorable mention definitely to Shawn Mendes. So,
we pretty much said everything we said. If you guys like this
video... Ooh, we got some more bands?
If you guys like this... No. If you guys like this video... leave a like on this video. If you guys want to leave a comment, let us know your best and worst. Feel free. Nobody watches at this point. If you do, say banana in the comments. Or just leave your best and worst, because that's would do the same thing. But if banana is what floats your banana boat, then do that. Subscribe. We're almost to 1,000, so subscribe. Subscribe. Did I tell them to subscribe? Dylan, did you tell them to subscribe?
Subscribe, yes.
Subscribe. The red button. Subscribe. I know you've been told in your life not to click the red button. Well, actually, the button's white now, it seems. I'm looking at the screen right now, and it seems the subscribe button's actually white now.
If you're on dark mode.
If you're on dark mode, it's white. If you're on the bright mode, it's red. So either way, click that. It says subscribe. If you can read, if you want to just email me, if you just want to mail me your laptop or phone, and I'll subscribe for you. If you can't read, that's fine. You know, there's... We accept people of all kinds. What have I forgotten? I'm fucking up the script now. Oh, thank you guys for watching this video. Dylan, I think is where you say goodbye. I said everything. I just didn't promote the Houdini and Toby remix, which you can check out in the description.
So goodbye.
Bye, fellas!